Perhaps we'll start with Paula.
Well, I'm here to support Mr. Trump because he's going to make America great again. And I think everybody else should vote for him. And I think they should all look at the fact that he's a good person. He's not what other people have been saying he's been, like Hillary. So think about that.
Okay. Kathy Shelton.
Yes, I'm also here to support Trump. At 12 years old, Hillary put me through something that you would never put a 12-year-old through. And she says she's for women and children. And she was asked last year on what happened, and she says she's supposed to defend whether they did it or not. Now she's laughing on tape, saying she knows they did it.
You went through a lot.
Yes, yes, sir, I did.
Okay. Hi, I'm Juanita Broderick, and I'm here to support Donald Trump. I tweeted recently, and Mr. Trump retweeted it, that actions speak louder than words. Mr. Trump may have said some bad words, but Bill Clinton raped me, and Hillary Clinton threatened me. I don't think there's any comparison.
I'm Kathleen Lilly, and I am here to support Donald Trump. The reason for that is the first day that he announced for president, he said, "I love this country, and I want America to be great again." And I cried when he said that, because I think that this is the greatest country in the world. I think that we can do anything. I think we can accomplish anything. I think that we can bring peace to this world, and I think Donald Trump can lead us to that point.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Okay, thank you all very much. We appreciate it.
Mr. Trump, you touched women without their consent. Mr. Trump, why did you say you touched women without consent, Mr. Trump?
Why don't y'all ask Bill Clinton that? Why don't y'all go ask Bill Clinton that? Go ahead and ask Hillary as well.
And you just heard that right there. And we have some breaking news right now on where those women will be tonight. As we said, they just appeared with Donald Trump at a hotel near here, Sarah Murray. They will be in the debate hall tonight, you're learning?
Aaron, that is what the Trump campaign is telling me right now, that those four women will be in the debate hall. Now, even though Trump's advisors have not admitted one way or another whether all of this would come up on the debate stage, obviously this sends a very strong signal. And Aaron, I can't tell you how many Republicans have been telling me they did not want to see Donald Trump go this route. They believe that Hillary Clinton could get the best of him on this. They believe that it could backfire on him, particularly in light of the tape that's come out about him this week. So there are certainly going to be plenty of nervous Republicans seeing this video and also seeing these women in the hall tonight. Aaron.
Sarah, thank you very much. Gloria, a pretty stunning development. This is something
stunning.
Nobody expected to happen.
It's kind of dark and you know, in a way, very sad. And I think that politically, it's particularly stunning because I'm not so sure what this does for Donald Trump. If you look at it just purely politically, I don't know whose mind he changed. If you're, you know, an undecided voter, will you then suddenly say Donald Trump is a champion for women? And does this suddenly erase what occurred on the videotape? I don't think so. I think that it shows you that Donald Trump is willing to do anything to kind of win. And this is not, you know, just to finish for one sec, as Sarah is saying, and the Republicans that I've talked to, and you've heard from Newt Gingrich today and others, this is exactly where they did not want him to go. Now, maybe he won't do it in the debate, and he did it here, and it's head fake and he got it out of the way. That's a possibility.
Yeah, but now, they're going to be in the room.
I said a few minutes ago, and I quite agreed with her, that what he needed to do was offer a statement of genuine contrition,
right,
and then address himself to the issues that were important to people in their lives. If he goes this route, if this becomes a major part of his evening, then I think the answer to your question earlier, is this the day the campaign ended officially, I would say yes. Look, the question has always been, how does a reality show star get himself elected president? Apparently he feels it's by turning a presidential.
Hey guys, welcome everybody. You're watching AMTV Live. This is the presidential debate round two, and kind of unprecedented. Trump sits down with Juanita Broderick, it looks like Kathleen Willey. They're making this public statement, this kind of wild card before the debate. I actually think this is a mistake, what he just did. This is what I argued against in the video that we had uploaded before this, is that he should not and cannot fall into Hillary Clinton's trap, which is exactly what he's doing right now. Sinking into the gutter along with Hillary, which is exactly where she wants Donald Trump. So I think that this is a mistake. I do not think this is a good thing. And, you know, just looking at this with a critical eye, this doesn't work in his favor at all. Now, maybe as one of the commentators said, this is a head fake, and then he just doesn't say anything about this at the debate. We'll learn and see if that's the case when the debate starts here in roughly an hour. And also, let me know, guys, if you can hear me okay, because we've got a couple different things going. I want to make sure that you can comment, hear me, the audio is okay, et cetera. Let's go back to the video and see what's happening now.
Are American citizens. These women have been relegated to telling their story on Breitbart News because other outlets won't pick them up. These women have a right to speak out. Their attorneys have attained a deposition. Hold on, I let you finish. Their attorneys have attained a deposition that says Hillary's attorneys hired private investigators to go after the three women on the left. Now, it's important that these millennials behind me, who care very deeply about sexual assault, I've been on a college campus for the last seven years of my life, and I can tell you this, sexual assault's a big issue.
Good.
The three women on the left, Hillary awesome. Hired private investigators to look after. The woman on the far white,
then
right,
folks, this is
Hillary Clinton
politics.
Has an
Welcome
audio tape laughing at the girl, bragging about how she got
right
the
now.
Innocent rapist off.
Can I
really
look at the They all have a right to
Donald,
be heard. I want to hear their stories.
About
I want to know all the facts.
And now we do on it.
Now let me finish. But as my parents raised me to say, time and a place, and a debate, which is supposed to be about independent voters and a variety of issues, will become a blank show. I'd say it. It would probably end up on a Trump audio if I said it. And I don't think that's necessarily the best
interest. Michael, he might not bring it up. These women got to speak for themselves tonight without Donald Trump having to say a word. That's a victory for the American.
So, Jeffrey, what about this? Now, you have it. Let's just say he doesn't bring it up. Who knows whether he will or won't. But the head fake that David suggested, say that's what it is. You now have them sitting in the audience. You have Bill Clinton sitting in the same room that they were sitting in.
Right.
How does that play?
Well, this is what I find so fascinating here. The age-old allegation, having nothing to do with this campaign, everything to do with it, but that goes back decades, is that the media, writ large, the mainstream media, is always giving an unfair shake to Republicans. What they've just done here is get this out into the conservative media stream, whether it's picked up, and obviously it is picked up right here on CNN. And to get this everywhere, you can be guaranteed that tomorrow morning or tomorrow noon, when Rush Limbaugh hits the airwaves, that this will be topic A.
Speaking to the people.
Hold on. Paul, you were there during all of this. I mean, you were there, you were advising. What is the significance of this moment to Hillary Clinton tonight? She sees this. You saw her senior campaign staff were there. Jeff Zeleny was there when they heard about this. They were surprised. Does this affect her performance, her psyche, what she does tonight?
Okay, let's refresh so we're true live.
This election is a choice between two very different candidates. Before proudly voting for Obamacare.
That's unprecedented. In the modern era. And so,
folks, we've
got
just
to do
about
something
an hour.
He clearly thinks this is the strategy. I disagree. I don't think it'll work.
Especially
at town hall,
the
tussle is whose election is this? Does this election belong to Donald Trump? Does it belong to Hillary Clinton? Or does it belong to we the people? This I think,
America.
Trump is definitely trying to make a play to hijack the election away from the needs and concerns of those voters and make it about himself, make it about Hillary, make it about Hillary's husband. I don't think that's a winning strategy.
What up, JC? How you doing, brother?
So this is a character test for Donald Trump. And
It's an ink blot test whether he passed it.
Please share this video right now. Get it out to your friends and family. This live stream right now. Share it on Twitter. Share it on Facebook. It looks like, and this is good that we're testing this now because it looks like our stream just went offline, the one that we're using. So we'll see if we can't refresh that. Interesting. See, we've already got a copyright claim by Turner CNN, so we're going to have to find a different stream here. So if our producer is listening, we need to find a different stream. Maybe we'll use C-SPAN or something like that. Let me see if I can find it here. Copyright claims. Okay, looks like we're going to try C-SPAN here. So again, folks, what we just saw, unprecedented. Donald Trump does a press conference with Juanita Broderick, who just relived her rape like 24 hours ago. I played this footage where she describes in vivid detail Bill ripping off her blouse, forcing her onto a bed, and engaging in sex against her will. Just a violent man and a violent sexual predator that Hillary Rotten Clinton fully endorses and is an accomplice to these rape allegations. And again, folks, we're talking 16 odd women that we know about and probably hundreds more, just like Bill Cosby. Both of these men, sexual predators. Absolutely incredible. And I hope Donald Trump isn't barking up this tree all night, because if he is, he's in a lot of trouble. It's not going to resonate with the American people. Stooping down to a debate where all we can talk about is vaginas. Okay, it's not going to work. Even though we're all smart enough to understand there's a very big difference between what a man said 10 years ago on a bus when he didn't know he was being hot mic'd recorded, and something I don't endorse or condone at all, but he apologized for it, versus a sharp contrast to rape, which is what Bill has. It looks like my phone's ringing here. It's our producer. Yeah, hey, how you doing, man? Okay, no problem. Hold on 1 second. Let me detach myself. Our stream broke, too, so I had to go over to C-SPAN. Okay, so give me a second here. We will be right back, everybody. I'm going to put myself on mute. Remind me to plug in there again, because I'm going to try to pick up the stream from a different... Everybody, let me know if you can hear me now. So the original stream we were using has been booted, courtesy of Turner Broadcasting, CNN. Again, they just can't handle the truth. Let me know if you can hear me. Maybe I'll go to some comments here. We picked up a new stream off C-SPAN, which will hopefully let us stream that and commentate on that in real time. So hopefully they don't boot us. If they do, we're going to have to pop back on as we're dealing with this. So let me know if you've got audio. Looks like you guys have visual. Okay, Jonathan says, you got me. Loud and clear, Prepper in America. Okay, good. Audio good. Robert Sylvester, good. Good. Great. So while we're waiting, gals and guys, what questions do you have for me? Again, kind of an unprecedented moment. Donald Trump has his press conference with Juanita Broderick, Kathleen Willey. I don't think we've ever seen anything like this in American history. If he stays on this issue tonight, it's going to be a problem, because I really do think this is a critical, critical juncture, and this is gutter politics. And he has to avoid sinking to the low that makes up the scum of the earth that is Hillary Rotten Clinton and her husband, who have been sitting on, I guarantee, were sitting on the Trump dump for months, just waiting for the perfect time. And again, you know, Dems have no problem with people like JFK, who had, you know, dozens of affairs in the Oval Office and was just banging women on a regular basis. I mean, they love him. A great guy. His family are bootleggers, too. They love him for that, too. Versus Trump, who just made, like, a lewd comment that they had to go through all this footage from a decade ago. They had to thumb through it. They probably spent months just finding the right material, and then they've just been waiting to make the dump, which they did on the same day, not coincidentally, that the WikiLeaks dump came out and the John Podesta emails came out on history's ties to Hillary Clinton's ties to Wall Street, the fact that she's totally disconnected from her constituents and her base because this person is an elitist. And again, she's a criminal. So what Donald Trump should focus on tonight are the real issues: jobs, the economy, egregious wars in the Middle East, the new war that Hillary Clinton, the Secretary of State, started in Syria, the death of 500,000 civilians in that country alone, a criminal Federal Reserve, a national debt, $20+ trillion. I mean, those would just be some good things to start with, not to mention the gross surveillance state that makes up the National Spying Agency today, which is something we'll see, but I would almost guarantee they avoid tonight. Like, are you gonna stop spying on us? I mean, because all of you out there, as I said in my rant earlier, are also being recorded via hot mic. It's called a cell phone. Especially you liberal retards out there, you're also being recorded. So anything you say or do, or have done in the past, any mistakes you've made, commentary you've made behind the scenes, maybe you lost your temper, but you were in the privacy of your own home. Maybe you were taking a shit on your toilet this morning. Maybe you're masturbating or something like that. They can and will use that against you, because they've got a hot mic in your hands too. It's called the gross surveillance state that makes up the good old USSA today. Mark my words, folks, there's going to be consequences to all this. There's going to be grave consequences to all of this. An economic collapse, escalation of war in places like Syria, and the country is extremely divided. Over half the country that's pro-Trump doesn't agree with these radical, leftist, liberal scum. These idiots that are indoctrinated by the machine that makes up the propaganda web that is the Clinton News Network and this controlled opposition in America today. Now, it's our job to educate. It's our job to enlighten to the truth. But you have to understand, most of America, they're spoon-fed this bullshit, and they believe it. They could give a rat's ass about Hillary Clinton and her Benghazi gate scandal, or the death of Christopher Stevens and several other Americans. The fact that they were running and trafficking guns into Syria and arming and creating ISIS, which didn't even exist up until Hillary Clinton became Secretary of the State, and the Manchurian candidate that made up Barack Obama became the President of the United States and had his two terms to radicalize America. Could care two shits about that. They could care two shits about the Clinton Foundation padding their pockets with record amounts of money, hundreds of millions of dollars, a pay-to-play scam from foreign entities, governments, politicians, countries like Saudi Arabia that are, by the way, Hillary Clinton, if you don't know already, horrible to women. Hate women. But she has no problem taking their money. But she's a feminist, right? An accomplice to Bill Clinton's alleged rapes and sexual assaults. But again, we know all this. Most Americans, they're not going to care, which is why Donald Trump can't stoop this low. He should let Hillary stoop as low as she wants to go tonight. And if she starts going that direction, go like, look, Hillary, I apologize. I made a mistake, but there's a big difference between a lewd comment that I made off camera and things that your husband have been accused of. But I'm not going to stoop that low tonight, and I don't want to focus on that tonight. I want to focus on real issues. So if you want to go there, go for it. But I'm going to talk about jobs, the economy, the Middle East, the surveillance state, Wall Street, the criminal Federal Reserve, the stock market bubble. I mean, there's so many things that he could hit and that he could be presidential and will resonate with the American people versus Anderson Cooper coming on camera and asking us about the fact if Donald Trump had talked about some woman's vagina. You know, Donald Trump said so himself that Bill has said far worse and made far worse commentary in his ear on the golf course that makes Donald look like a freaking baby. And you know what? I believe him. I bet Bill is the most crass MF-er you probably would ever meet. Charismatic, yes, but a rapist also, according to Juanita Broderick and others. And many more coming forward, by the way. So we are about 40 minutes in. I want to welcome everybody. Thank you. Share our live stream. Hopefully it doesn't get cut. We already had a copyright claim by CNN, the Clinton News Network, because, again, they want to shut down the truth. I mean, God forbid we speak on YouTube, which is supposed to be about you guys, and broadcast through the monopolies that are so connected with the government today that they are big government in the United States of America. So I'm looking at a couple of your questions here. I want to welcome everybody. Share this stream. Get it out. Fulvio says, you are the truth. Someone asks, who will win? Well, I hope Donald Trump, but if he doesn't play his cards right, this could be his Achilles heel. He needs to be presidential. I'm hoping he's smart enough. And let's give him the benefit of the doubt that he's using this initial press conference to just throw Hillary Clinton and her campaign off. It could actually be a good tactic. But he better know what he's doing, because what he just did is dangerous and risky and either will be very detrimental tonight if he continues on this path or could be probably the best strategic bombshell he ever dropped. Donald Trump's smart. He's a media guy. So who will win? You have to go back to some of my previous videos, but I think, honestly, this comes down, as my original thesis was, that this comes down to a gnat's ass. Donald Trump is America's catharsis. Americans think that, you know, they've got a chance with Donald Trump, and that's where all the populist anger goes, and the New World Order elites rig the table to Hillary anyway. And people think they were this close to winning. I actually think a more important question is, to feed off that question, is what comes next? See, these bombshells aren't finished yet. Julian Assange of WikiLeaks has more damning and damaging information on Hillary. He's also waiting for the perfect moment to drop the bombshell. It wasn't just the Podesta emails that they just released, which were damaging in and of themselves. Same reason Hillary Clinton was desperately grasping at straws a few days ago and came out with, you know, these statements from Donald, what was it, on Friday, about something he said, you know, lewd locker room commentary with somebody off camera. Very, very critical debate. Somebody says, if Donald Trump loses, then he should become Batman. Then again, idiots vote in this election. That's from another subscriber. Jesse says, I don't want to get nuked. Well, I don't either. And you know, Hillary Clinton is far more dangerous. Far more dangerous to countries like Russia and China, for example, than it would be under a Trump presidency. Hillary Clinton starts wars. She wants war. She pushes people like Russia around. Donald Trump says, hey, he wants to be diplomatic about it. Yeah, he wants to meet with Putin, have a conversation. He's going to be strong, but, you know, he doesn't want to go to war. Hillary Clinton doesn't just not want to go to war. She's at war. What do you think Syria is? What do you think Libya was? What do you think the controlled, although there's some organic elements to it, the controlled Arab Spring protest slash revolution was? You don't think that was inspired and covertly operated by Western interests? You've got to be kidding me. Of course it was. The revolution and re-revolution of Egypt, for example. So things are so, so dangerous right now. You know, Putin just held a drill for some 40 million Russians preparing for a schizophrenic America that might bomb the shit out of them out of the blue. Now, yes, this is a propaganda war. Yes, this is an intelligence war. But this is real, folks. This is real. And it's so, so dangerous. And Hillary Clinton is dangerous. And again, folks, she is gutter trash. She is worse than the scum beneath my shoe, or that ring, you know, that just kind of develops on the toilet and just sits there if you don't bleach it from time to time. That's her and Bill. They're that ring around the toilet. They need to be flushed down that toilet. This isn't America anymore. We've been hijacked. And it only illustrates how divided we are. Not united, but divided. And as I said and paraphrased a bit in my last rant, from time to time, the tree of liberty must be refreshed with the blood of tyrants and patriots. And this is what it's coming to in America. This vast Orwellian police state that, again, we can barely broadcast. I'm telling you guys all the time, price of a cup of coffee, $4.95 a month, $49.95 a year, helps us build our infrastructure. We need your help. We need funding. We can't do it without you. This is what we're facing. Bullshit. On a day-to-day basis. And it's getting harder and harder to spread the truth and to enlighten others to what's really going on. Because that propaganda machine is powerful. And they have multi-billion dollar moneyed interests supporting the message that makes up CNN, the Clinton News Network, and Faux News, and MSNBC, and even what they say, you know, conservative. Oh, Fox is conservative. Oh, you know, it's giving us a different angle. Not really. One world, new world order government. It's a singular focus. Divide and conquer. Pretend the Democrats and Republicans are different. I mean, there's barely any Republicans supporting Donald Trump at this point. Now, we saw all the evangelicals. They had to, you know, pull back their support as well here recently based on the vagina talk. Because God forbid if an evangelical has ever seen a vagina before. I mean, you know, they probably don't even, I mean, I'm not even going to go there. But it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous that this is what America has come to, that tonight, arguably the most important presidential debate in history, what makes up America today, just a few short hundred years since we've already screwed it up, instead of talking about real issues tonight, it's just going to be about vagina talk. And Anderson Pooper's there, ready with his prepared questions that have been handed to him by the network. And he's just going to beat up on Donald Trump, just like Lester Holt. He probably won't ask a single... Maybe he'll throw one in. Maybe, because there's been so much criticism. But he probably won't ask a question. You know what? My gut tells me he actually probably will tonight. He will probably ask a question on the Clinton Foundation. Because he kind of has to. Because everybody knows the last one was so freaking rigged. That made up, you know, WNBC. WNBC. Probably remember, was it Howard Stern saying that? I always thought it was funny when he said that. To count down, folks, 33 minutes before we go live via C-SPAN. Hopefully they're a little more friendly to this presentation tonight so we can actually commentate on it. They don't, you know, cut it down and cut our legs off, which is what is normally done. Again, share this, guys, everywhere. This stream, this video with your friends and family right now. Bring more people here. Ask me a question. Let's watch this together. Let's do it in real time. Scrolling through your comments here, looks like we've got quite a few people. Someone says Trump can end the witch hunt tonight. And plug my audio source into here so when we get started, if I remember to do it. Somebody says, unfortunately, I believe Hitlery has already been chosen. No hope for America. How did not more of you recognize this behavior in the primaries? Trump pushes this division. He is not a man of unity. Neither of them are. Share the link. Thank you. Thank you, Edward. Appreciate that. Thank you for sharing the link. Somebody says Hillary sold 20% of U.S. uranium to Russia, but that's not suspicious at all. Yeah, not at all. That's not suspicious. Google control information on the internet about Clinton possible election. Art says, are the elections already decided behind closed doors? Yep, unfortunately. Of course they are. I mean, do we really think that the President of the United States, he doesn't make decisions either, okay? Right? The President of the United States takes orders from those that really run the country. They read teleprompters. I mean, I've argued this for some time. I actually think Donald Trump is far more dangerous if he loses. And he continues with his media campaign, and he continues as a maverick. Then he might be if he becomes president of the United States, which I want him to be, and is just controlled by, you know, the real puppet masters, people like George Soros and others, and the international banks or elites. I mean, this is something Hillary Clinton even admitted to through the Podesta email dump that we just got from WikiLeaks. You know, saying things like, well, you know, of course I need money from Wall Street, or I couldn't even run for president. Very, very dangerous, folks. Just make sure our volume is going here. Again, we are tuned in live with about 30 minutes to go. We're watching a live stream here live with AMTV. We've switched from CNN, the Clinton News Network, since they already shut it down. And had a copyright infringement, as many of you saw, and now we're with C-SPAN. So C-SPAN shuts us down, we'll try to go somewhere else, and then we'll try to go somewhere else, and we'll just keep bumping around as, you know, big tech and big media continues to want to shut down the truth. Again, why we need your support. Let's go to the Drudge Report real quick. Hopefully it doesn't screw up our screen. We can just see here on the left-hand corner, Trump presents Clinton accusers. Shock video. I played this earlier. Broderick relives brutal rapes. I mean, it's just so horrible watching her break down with her Kleenex. You know, Kathleen Willey coming to her side. She's like just reliving the horrific moment that made up this sexual predator that is Bill Clinton, who just rapes women because he thinks he's all too powerful. These are the accusations that these women are making, and they are shocking. You know, Bill's victims terrified of enabler Hillary, of accomplice, an accomplice to these rapes. I mean, it's like Don Corleone. It's the mobster. It's a mobster family. You come to me out of respect, I'll make you an offer you can't refuse. I mean, at least the mob, you kind of know what you're going to get with them. They only kill each other. Hillary goes out and kills, you know, if you've seen the Clinton body count, a lot of people. You know, at least with the mobsters, you know, they've got respect. You know, you kind of know what you're getting into, but not with people like Hillary. So I just hope this doesn't become, you know, just one big rape, trash-talking fiesta. I do not think that is an effective strategy for Donald Trump. Now, maybe it's effective coming out with this press conference with a wild card, because, I mean, dude, it's throwing off the game plan that Hillary Clinton and her, you know, camp has been studying for weeks now and days now. She does her homework, you know, preparing for this debate. Maybe. So now I would say Trump transition, be presidential, focus on the real issues, move away from the gutter trash that makes up Hillary Clinton. I'd call her gutter trash on camera, maybe. Just, you're in the gutter, and this is trash. And I don't want to talk about it. If you do, go ahead. He does need to be tough. He should get angry. I mean, if Hillary Clinton questions his integrity, he better raise his voice. He better get pissed off. Question my integrity? America questions your integrity, Hillary. An enabler of Bill Clinton. You call yourself a feminist. You're not a feminist. What you are is a manipulator. Survive at any cost, right, Hillary? Do whatever it takes, right, Hillary? Who cares if your husband's a rapist? You need him to get to this next position of power. It's just, that's what she wants. They just want power. Very evil. Gutter trash. Again, they ring around my toilet. 27 minutes and counting. See if I can go to some more news here on my cell phone, as well as see some of your beautiful, beautiful comments. Again, welcome everybody. Thank you for spending this time with me. I really appreciate it. You know, I'm humbled by it. Gutter nuts, David says. Ava says, okay, calm down there. Calm down. All right, Ava, we'll calm down. We'll calm down. Jay says Trump is Satan. Really, Jay? Really, Jay? Okay, can you explain that? What's your take? I'm actually curious. Put in the comments. Is he the Antichrist in Europe? Like, is that your take? I'm curious. Robert says Hillary's funded by big banks and the media, these conglomerates. You know, Will says, Will Fargo, welcome, Will. He says, you know, he needs to audit the Federal Reserve, referring to Donald Trump. Audit? I don't know, man. A lot of people say, oh, we need an audit. We need a reform. End, in my opinion. Abolish. Shut down. Again, the whole thing's an illusion. It's not sound money. It isn't a sound system. The whole thing's an illusion. America's entire money system, an illusion. Our entire economy, an illusion. Working on this hookerdom. That's a malaprop I just came up with. Of America today. 0% interest rates. Yeah, take out your mortgage. I even saw an ad the other day. I do my business with the local credit union because I shun all the big banks, the too big to fail banks. And I saw this ad that, you know, just kind of made me laugh out loud. It was like something like, follow your heart into a new mortgage today. And it like shows a picture of a house, like, follow your heart into chains. Follow your heart into more debt so you can barely make your minimum monthly payment. Oh yeah, it's so freeing, isn't it? What a free society. You know what, if mortgages didn't exist in this phony money credit system that the Federal Reserve came up with, it is based on nothing, didn't exist, home prices would just crater. You could actually afford to buy a house with cash. It would actually be worth something, you know, instead of a house being $300,000. If you let the free market take root and supply and demand actually work, that same house probably be worth like $25,000. But it's because of credit and easy money, they get to inflate the prices and rape you. So yeah, that's right, folks. Follow your heart into chains. Follow your heart into more debt, mortgages, car loans, credit card debt. Isn't America great? Welcome to America. It's wonderful. Bullshit is what it is. Ooh, Deanna says, I bet Hillary is fuming. I can see her nostrils probably flaring, just fire coming out. You know, smoke coming out of her ears. Oh, I bet she is fuming. Probably had to put a diaper on because she pissed her pants and probably will piss her pants tonight. I wonder if we're going to get another coughing attack from Hillary Clinton. Will she collapse again tonight? She made it through the last one, probably because they shot her up with multiple, you know, steroids or something like that and, you know, some cocaine or something to keep her up for the hour and a half that she had to stand. But will she collapse tonight? Will she give us one of these crazy Parkinson, what looks like Parkinson-related symptoms where, you know, her head bobs all around, her eyes, you know, go all over the place, cockeyed Hillary? Ka-ka! It's possible. Never seen anything. I mean, it is good entertainment, right? This is the bread and circus, all you guys have been waiting for, right? Yeah, right-left paradigm. Oh, yeah, Republican versus Democrat. Oh, it's so great. I guess it is. Free entertainment, I guess, kind of, sort of. I mean, it's better than going to the movies. Most people probably aren't even tuning in tonight. They're watching football. I don't even know who's playing tonight, but I'm sure most America does, and that's what they're watching. They're like, eh, I don't know. I'll just listen to what CNN tells me to believe after the debate. I'll just read a couple articles. They'll tell me to hate on Donald Trump, so I'll just hate him. I won't have any fundamental evidence to, but, yeah, you know, I'll just take CNN's word for it. The Clinton News Network. 22 minutes and counting, folks. Let's just do another audio-visual check from you. Give me a green light, thumbs up in the comment section that you can see me and you can hear me. In 22 minutes, countdown here will be starting. And hold on to your hats. Woo! It's going to be fun. MLG Toast says, if you answer me, I'll love you. And sub. I'm waiting, MLG. I'm waiting for your subscription. Good to have you. Welcome. Raw Punk says, feel the burn. Feel the burn. Yeah, yeah. Feel the burn of the sellout that makes Bernie Sanders. Makes up Bernie Sanders, who I told you from the get-go, nothing wrong with his politics, although, you know, there's some good things I think that he's talked about. Don't agree with, you know, a lot of it, but we always knew, and this is what I said from the get-go, the very beginning, that he was going to endorse Hillary Clinton because he's a freaking puppet, and it's exactly what he did. Either that, or Hillary put the equivalent of a gun to his head and said, you better endorse me or this is going to happen. Now, I wouldn't put it past her. Riff says, gay. Marco says, yes, I'd rather have Christopher as president. God, I don't even know if I'd want the job, to be honest with you. Okay, okay, let's see here. There's two ways to pronounce this. Eva? Is it Eva? Not Eva? I'm guessing Eva, then. I'm guessing. E-V-A. Zombie-fied says, Hitlery makes me sick. Biff says, do you think Trump is lying that he wants to be friendly with Russia? No. I don't, but Trump is smart, man. He's a negotiator, right? That's what you need to understand. I mean, he knows how to negotiate. He's a marketer. He's a salesman. You know, he sells you up here with an idea. He's a showman. What did we just see with this previous announcement with Juanita Broderick and appeared to be Kathleen Willey? He's a showman, man. He sells you up here. He kind of delivers here. Same thing with the wall. And I think he will be held accountable to those things. He's got to build a wall, et cetera. But he probably meets somewhere in the middle if and when he does become president of the United States. Okay, thank you, Arthur. That's very helpful, too. We'll try that. He says, Chris, this is live. Donald Trump live second debate 2016. So I'm sure Trump's probably running it, too. So maybe we'll head over there if we've got to. If we've got our problem with C-SPAN. Again, we're about 20 minutes out. Like, isn't it crazy, though, really? Like, there's this much trash talking. Like, America is just a gutter, right? I mean, this is what it's come to. Really just zombies walking in the streets. Just zombies. It's freaking crazy. Like, it really is. I was chatting with some friends the other day. I'm like, I can't imagine what people used to do prior to cell phones. Like, did they actually have a conversation with people? Because they're just freaking zombies now. It's irritating. Storm Shadow says, yes, thank you, AMTV. Thank you. Strom Shadows, it is. Strom Shadows. Minimum Wage says, Putin for president. Okay, go to channel Donald Trump Live. So, okay, we'll check that out. That's our backup plan. A lot of comments here. You guys are keeping me busy. Somebody says, from Richard, Clinton News Network and Hillary versus Trump. CNN supports Trump 100%. CNN loves Saudi. I won't say the next word. Sorry, I mean money, oil. Art says, Putin, Trump for world peace. No nukes. Ignacio says, we're doomed. Colonel says, uff you, liberals. F you, liberals. All right, guys, countdown. 18 minutes, 29 seconds. We're ready. Let me refresh here. Sweet. Got a lot of people tuning in. It's great to have you guys all here. Again, keep sharing. You know, it's kind of like what they used to do with books, you know. They just want to burn information, burn books. Right, the more they want to burn things down, shut it down, the more popular we'll become. Keep sharing it. Share the underground. Share the truth. share enlightenment. It's amazing. Amazing. You know, if you're watching us, maybe you just pulled this up on YouTube for the first time and you've never even heard of AMTV, welcome. Welcome. You're going to get commentary tonight you'll never get anywhere else. And I like to preface today's show with letting you know that Hillary Clinton is trash. She's trash. She's gutter trash. So I want to welcome you if you're visiting. And maybe you're a liberal. Stick around. Love to have you here. Maybe we'll open your eyes a little bit. You can decide for yourself. Don't take my word for it. We'll comment tonight and commentate on everything that's going on in real time. It'd be great to have you here. Again, it's all about education, folks. It's about truth, enlightenment, discovery, but it's about education. And if you're a Republican or an independent or a freedom fighter or a radical, welcome as well. Great to have you here. This is what it's all about, folks. This is America today. Gutter trash. Talking about vaginas today on camera. That's what we'll be talking about. That's the debate's focus. Donald Trump said this about a woman in 2010 when he was coming off a bus from Access Hollywood over a hot mic when he didn't know he was being recorded in private. And he was having boys' men's bathroom talk and making lewd commentary behind the scenes. And Hillary Clinton, because she's such scum, had her team of operatives go through all the files and footage and all this kinds of thing just so they could pluck it and drop it right on the Clinton News Network. Isn't that great? She's such a wonderful lady, isn't she? Such a feminist. We just love her. We love her so much. Foot's falling asleep here. I'm going to have to probably like stand and sit since we've been here a while. Maybe we'll do one of those broadcasts in the future where it's like 24, 48 hours or something. We'll do like a big fundraiser around it. I'll just be on camera for like ever. I'll be sleeping here with my pillow. You know, commenting, just, you know, trying to raise awareness for the platform or something. It'd be great. It'd be awesome. 15 minutes and counting. Hold on to your hats. This is pretty darn exciting, folks. Pretty darn exciting. Lock Raptor says Trump will be assassinated like Kennedy if he's really anti-establishment, also known as secret societies globally. Well, I'll tell you this, Lock. Anything and everything is on the table. Hope to God that doesn't happen, and I pray that that doesn't happen. I wouldn't wish the worst on anybody. Brandon says, hard-hitting and in your blank mouth. Keeps digging. Seven says treason. Stand here, stretch myself a little bit. Make sure I don't lose that. Okay, RT is another backup too. We'll try to move to that stream if we need to. So those are two backups. If you're just joining us now, we were booted from the CNN live stream because, again, they want to shut down the truth. And these too big to fail media giants and make up social media monopolies today like YouTube, Facebook, etc. want to shut us down, right? It's why Milo was banned from Twitter and all these people. If you're too controversial, and you're not sanitized like Anderson Cooper. If you're not sanitized, if there's not a sanitized message, they want to shut it down. If you're not Don Lemon or Anderson. It's funny, I was reading that Bill O'Reilly, I was reading one of his books, he was just talking about how he's like the most controversial figure in media or something. I'm like, really? You're the most controversial figure in media? I really don't think you're controversial at all. Maybe in your own mind, Bill. Maybe that's also why you steal our freaking trademark, hard-hitting it in your face. Thank you, though. It's a compliment. The Colonel says, I love politics. Got a little okay sign from Nino. Will Fargo says, been listening to you, Chris, for 4 years. Thank you for waking me up. You're welcome. And thank you for subscribing and being a part of this amazing community. I learn from you guys all the time. Thank you for what you do. All of you do that tune in. Thank you. You know, if you've noticed, if you've been following me that long, you've noticed a lot of profound changes in me too. It's pretty cool. You know, a lot of growth in all of us with our community. I mean, look at the Trump train, man. This never would have happened 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 years ago until now, because everything's changing. That's why I knew instinctually, I just knew when Trump started running for, you know, president and running against all the GOPers like Jeb and all these people, I knew he would win. Just like I knew why our platform here has worked, because it's politically incorrect and it's no holes barred and it's uncensored and uncut, no bullshit, just cut through the bullshit of the mainstream media with a giant machete. Just like I've seen that work, I knew that Trump's campaign was going to work up until now. But now we're getting to the nitty-gritty, and I do think that this is rigged, folks. This is rigged. If he's not careful, and again, we put out a video earlier today, this whole sex talk, sex scandal that Hillary wants to put, you know, Donald Trump in a box and wants him to go down in the gutter, if he's not careful and he doesn't handle this appropriately, and this is keeping both camps, both campaigns on their toes, it could be his Achilles heel. I hope it's not. I'm putting out that warning because, you know, I think it's important to put that out there. I mean, look at this, 10 minutes, man, we're going live. This is freaking crazy, right? This is better than a movie. It's theater, political theater. Fake. Fakery. Someone asked, if Obama drones the convention, do you think he would still be president? Yeah, we've heard a lot of talk, you know, about that, you know, martial law will be declared. Obama will be like, oh, isn't this convenient? Yeah, I'm going to be president for a third term because, well, the entire Eastern Seaboard was nuked the other day. Yeah, as a result of our intervention in the Middle East, it looks like promoted some really bad things happening on our land. Again, Vladimir Putin is preparing 40 million Russians now for nuclear war, and all we get from the mainstream bullshit media here in the United States is about, you know, Kim Kardashian's, you know, latest robbery. I guess they found her diamond. Isn't that relevant? Oh, yeah, we all care about that. Oh, they found her diamond. Oh, oh, wow. She was bound and gagged in her bathtub. That's the story as Putin, a real leader, prepares his entire population for nuclear fallout and a nuclear winter in hell. Calls it schizophrenic America. There's some truth to that. 10 minutes and counting, folks. This is kind of like a NASA liftoff. I wonder what's going through Trump's head right now. He's probably like, you know, getting ready to fight. Hillary's just like cramming, like studying, you know. She's got like her operatives yelling in her ear right now. She's got like an earpiece in. They're like, say this about, you know, Donald. Go after him in the PUSSY card. God, these people are idiots. Really are. Caitlin says, Hillary for prison. Cosby says, glad I found the channel. Glad we found you, Cosby. Welcome to AMTV. Jesse Holmes says, Christopher, what do you think a perfect America would look like? Please answer. Well, I don't think there's ever a perfect anything. I don't think there's a perfect America, but I think the way that it was set up, the foundational principles, what our founding fathers had in mind, although imperfect, it's pretty much the best darn place that's ever... best country that's ever existed. I mean, it's worked largely for the last couple hundred years, but it's already gone down the toilet because the radical leftists, amateurian candidates like Barack Obama, working against it. That's why they set up branches of government and all these things, and we have checks and balances, and all this is, you know, for the reason of why we're here today, and now the country's divided, nobody trusts their own government anymore. I mean, this is what Hillary Clinton was talking about in the Podesta leak. Like that it's a problem if Americans lose faith in the financial system, for example. Oh yeah, you bet your ass it is. It's a very, very serious problem. People stop spending, they stop taking out debt, mortgages, car loans, credit cards, all that. I mean, we saw in 2008, 2009, how quickly it can all turn on a dime. Put a little seed of fear in Americans' minds, faucet turns off, everything stops. So again, I don't think it's a perfect union. I think it's an imperfect union, but it's the best darn thing we've had, and it's worked. 8 minutes and counting. Welcome, everybody, if you're just getting here. Colonel says only God the Father is perfect. That's a good answer. Richard says build a wall around Trump. Well, he does have a wall of Secret Service, although I don't know how he trusts them because the establishment doesn't like him and they don't want him to be president, so I don't know why he trusts Secret Service that, you know, are placed there on his behalf from the government. If I was him, and he probably does, I would have my private security team and the Secret Service there, but my private security team would be watching out for the Secret Service members I didn't trust. I mean, so build a wall around Trump. He's got a wall. I'll tell you, when we were in Prescott, he's got a wall around him. I mean, you can't get 100 yards near him, you know, barely. It's an iron curtain, essentially. FTRA 1987 says Trump for peace. Said Hans Schu, and hopefully I'm pronouncing your name, says correctly, why is this happening? Controlled demolition of America. It's exactly what these radical leftists want. Why do you think the borders are open? All this illegal immigration radically transforms America. And then when they become eventually naturalized or whatever it is, then, you know, guess who they vote for? Planned. Les says, watch for cheating. Yes, we'll be looking out for that tonight. 6 minutes and counting here. Rick says, Hillary for prison. All right, guys, just a couple minutes left here. This is a countdown. This is liftoff. This is, you're living through history, too. I mean, this is kind of one of the exciting things about it. I mean, if you're alive on this planet right now, speck of sand in this freaking universe, well, in the grand scheme, this is pretty much not that big of a deal. We're probably all kind of inconsequential, but in our minds, at least, this is probably the most historic event, one of the most historic events in American politics and American history, is we have arrived at a place and time in America today where we are completely, completely divided. Those who believe in the Constitution, freedom, liberty, those principles, old America, God, guns, all those things, sound money, and the radical leftists that are indoctrinated by the Clinton News Network. And there's truth to that. They don't really have their own real opinions because they don't really think. They just regurgitate and reiterate the rhetoric given to them and spoon-fed down their throat. Which you're going to get tonight. In fact, tune into Anderson Cooper and you'll get that tonight. They'll just put that spoon right in your mouth. 5 minutes and counting. Do one last audio check, visual. Make sure you guys got me. Looks like we got volume on this video. Hopefully they don't cut the stream. Share it. Because we got 5 minutes to go. Bring in some more friends and family. So you guys come into the comment section. Join us. Subscribe. Get our videos out. Please support us. On demand, $4.95 a month, $49.95 a year. Click the link below. Start your free 14-day trial. If you don't like it, heck, then don't stay. But you will. I know you're going to love it. And thank you for all of you that have subscribed already and that support us. It is invaluable, and we are truly humbled by it. And we are building something amazing here. And you, my friend, all of you are amazing. I'm pretty excited. This is going to be super, super interesting tonight. This is far more consequential and important than debate number one. Debate number one was just kind of like a test run for Trump. You know, he just kind of wanted to show that he's presidential. He didn't really go out, you know, out on the prowl too much. But like I said, he's got to be careful here. He's got to be careful. Don't sink, this is my advice to Trump, too much into the gutter. Let Hillary sink into the gutter. Take the gloves off on the real issues. Jobs, economy, war, Federal Reserve. Surveillance, those kinds of things. Let her be the one to bring up rape and all this stuff. And if she questions your integrity, your honor, your morality, hit her. Man, I'm sure they're, God, it must have taken like how many hours to make up Hillary tonight? Probably like 10. You know, because she kind of looks like a corpse. Have you ever noticed that? I mean, probably got like a spray gun of paint or something as they're putting her makeup on so that they can kind of enliven her up. Make sure she got some rose on her cheeks and those kinds of things. Make sure she looks like she's actually alive, even though she's not. She's kind of just like a vampire. 3 minutes counting down for liftoff. Hopefully the implosion of Hillary Clinton and not Donald Trump. I have faith Donald is smart enough to know how to handle tonight. I have faith. But we'll see. very, very dangerous the way that where this is headed. Very, very dangerous. Can't wait for the comments from Anderson Pooper. Let's see if it's just as much of a controlled narrative as it was last time from Lester Holt, courtesy of WNBC. Coffee cups like, holy F, you are entertaining. And then there's a couple other people telling me to go F myself. See, I love the haters. I love the trolls. You guys are welcome, man. Thank you, actually, for tuning in. I really appreciate it. Joe says, vaginas matter. Mm-hmm. They do. Someone sent me a Snapchat. Follow me on Snapchat if you're not already at AMTV Media. They sent me this little video footage of a squirrel. And they're like, black squirrel lives matter, Christopher. Black squirrel lives matter. No, Nino says views going through the roof. Awesome, man. That's awesome. Cool. Damn, says the Frankie. All right, guys, we're about to get started here. A minute 41 countdown. This is incredible. This is, honest to God, you're living through history right now. This is absolutely amazing. We're going to see in a minute 30 in real time how all this shakes down tonight. Last, I believe, commercial free from 6 to 7:30 Pacific time, you know, accordingly to wherever you're tuning in around the world. Whew, minute 13, here we go. Double check when it does start too, if you could just drop in the comment section as soon as this audio feed from C-SPAN comes up. Just make sure everything's working, you're getting visual audio. Let us know. Want to make sure that all this is working. Here we go, folks. October 9th, 2016, 5:59 p.m., 43 seconds left. This is our last stand, America. This is it. Let me sit down. Readjust that camera. Por favor. Thank you. 28, 27, 26, 25, 23, 22. Whew, I feel like we're at NASA right now. Thanks for joining us. I really appreciate it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hard hitting and in your face. Now it says, live stream is starting soon. All right, C-SPAN, where are you? We're ready for you. Give it a few seconds here. If not, we'll try another one. But I have faith. I have faith. You got to have faith, folks. You don't have faith, you don't have nothing. Let me hit refresh. Okay, looks like everything's going good on our end. We were waiting for C-SPAN. Come on, C-SPAN. There we go. There he is, Anderson Pooper in his gray hair. He just can't wait to attack on the vaginas. History. There's Ivanka, looking beautiful as always. She is a stunner. I've met her in person before. She's very pretty. There's the other Trump, kind of a goofy looking fellow in my opinion. One to the left, the goofiest looking probably, but both goofy. Washington University. presidential debate. This is like a hardcore Apprentice episode or something. Why do all the Trumps, they're always like their lip always does that. It's kind of weird. I'm getting audio. Let me double check too with our viewers here. Yes, I am. Mm-hmm. On this right here. No? Can you guys get audio? Okay, we see no audio. We're working on that right now. Can you hear me? Okay, so you guys can hear me, but no audio from the stream. We're working on it. Do you know why? Because I did start a new video. Because it's a different stream. That should work, though. Let me know if I need to move for you or something. Bear with us, folks. Well, you guys can hear me at least, so I'll at least commentate until we figure this out. Any idea why? This might make the noise real quick. Yeah. Turn that off. Should I refresh it? I don't know why. I'm hearing it here. Mm-hmm. We should be able to pick up the computer.
Good evening. I'm Martha Raddatz from ABC News.
And I'm Anderson Cooper from CNN. We want to welcome you to Washington University in St. Louis for the second presidential debate between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump, sponsored by the Commission on Presidential Debates. Tonight's debate is a town hall format, which gives voters a chance to directly ask the candidates questions. Martha and I will ask follow-up questions, but the night really belongs to the people in this room and to people across the country who have submitted questions online.
The people you see on this stage were chosen by the Gallup organization. They are all from the St. Louis area
and told Gallup they haven't
committed to a candidate.
Each
of them came
audio.
Here with questions they want to ask, and we saw those questions for the first time this morning. Anderson and I and our team from ABC and CNN are the only ones who have seen them. Both candidates will have 2 minutes to answer each audience and online question. We hope to get to as many questions as we can, so we've asked the audience here not to slow things down with any applause. Except for now.
Yeah. Make sure it's
ladies
a graveyard,
and gentlemen,
people.
The Republican
like
nominee for
home.
President, Donald J. Trump, and the Democratic nominee for President, Hillary Clinton. Hello.
Eggs shaking it. Hi. Sit down. That meet and greet was awesome, dude. That was cool.
Thank you very much for being here. We're
going to
begin with
other.
A question from one of the members in our town hall. Each of you will have 2 minutes to respond to this question. Secretary Clinton, you won the coin toss, so you'll go first. Our first question comes from Patrice.
She won the coin
Rock.
Toss.
Patrice?
Bullshit.
Thank you and good evening. The last presidential debate could have been rated as MA, mature audiences, per TV parental guidelines. Knowing that educators assign viewing the presidential debates as students' homework, do you feel you're modeling appropriate and positive behavior for today's youth?
Well, thank you. Are you a teacher? Yes, I think that that's a very good question because I've heard from lots of teachers and parents about some of their concerns about some of the things that are being said and done in this campaign. And I think it is very important for us to make clear to our children that our country really is great because we're good.
Trump's
and we are going to respect one another, lift each other up. We are going to be looking for ways to celebrate our diversity. And we are going to try to reach out to every boy and girl, as well as every adult.
Yeah, just like your
to
husband.
Bring them in to working on behalf of our country. I have a very positive and optimistic view about what we can do together. That's why the slogan of my campaign is Stronger Together. Because I think if we work together, if we overcome the divisiveness that sometimes sets Americans against one another, and instead we make some big goals, and I've set forth some big goals, getting the economy to work for everyone, not just those at the top, making sure that we have the best education system from preschool through college and making it affordable
system.
And so much else. If we set those goals and we go together to try to achieve them, there's nothing, in my opinion, that America can't do. So that's why I hope that we will come together in this campaign. Obviously, I'm hoping to earn your vote. I'm hoping to be elected in November. And I can promise you, I will work with every American. I want to be the president for all Americans, regardless of your political beliefs, where you
Not
come
me.
From, what you look like, your religion. I want us to heal
we
our country
you
and bring
you
it together.
Be in prison, so
because
sorry.
That's, I think, the best way for us to get the future that our children and our grandchildren deserve.
Secretary Clinton, thank you. Mr. Trump, you have 2 minutes.
Well, I actually agree with that. I agree with everything she said. I began this campaign because I was so tired of seeing such foolish things happen to our country. This is a great country. This is a great land. I've gotten to know the people of the country over the last year and a half that I've been doing this as a politician. I cannot believe I'm saying that about myself, but I guess I have been a politician. And my whole concept was to make America great again. When I watch the deals being made, when I watch what's happening with some horrible things like Obamacare, where your health insurance and health care is going up by numbers that are astronomical, 68%, 59%, 71%. When I look at the Iran deal and how bad a deal it is for us, it's a one-sided transaction where we're giving back $150 billion to a terrorist state, really the number one terrorist state. We've made them a strong country from really a very weak country just 3 years ago. When I look at all of the things that I see and all of the potential that our country has, we have such tremendous potential, whether it's in business and trade, where we're doing so badly. Last year, we had an almost $800 billion trade deficit. In other words, trading with other countries, we had an $800 billion deficit. It's hard to believe, inconceivable. You say, who's making these deals? We're going to make great trade deals. We're going to have a strong border. We're going to bring back law and order. Just today, policeman was shot, two killed, and this is happening on a weekly basis. We have to bring back respect to law enforcement. At the same time, we have to take care of people on all sides. We need justice. But I want to do things that haven't been done, including fixing and making our inner cities better for the African-American citizens that are so great, and for the Latinos, Hispanics. And I look forward to doing it. It's called Make America Great Again.
Thank you, Mr. Trump.
Okay, that's a good opener.
The question from Patrice was about, are you both modeling positive and appropriate behaviors for today's youth?
First question about
we received
vagina.
A lot of questions online, Mr. Trump, about the tape that was released on Friday, as you can imagine.
You. Sorry.
You called what you said locker room banter. You described kissing women without consent, grabbing their genitals. That is sexual assault. You bragged that you have sexually assaulted women. Do you understand that?
No, I didn't say that at all. I don't think you understood what was said. This was locker room talk. I'm not proud of it. I apologize to my family. I apologize to the American people. Certainly, I'm not proud
Gutter
of
politics.
It. But this is locker room talk. You know, when we have a world where you have ISIS chopping off heads, where you have, and frankly, drowning people in steel cages, where you have wars and horrible, horrible sights all over, where you have so many bad things happening. This is like medieval times. We haven't seen anything like this, the carnage all over the world.
Through that.
And they look and they see. Can you imagine the people that are frankly doing so well against us with ISIS? And they look at our country and they see what's going on. Yes, I'm very embarrassed by it. I hate it.
but it's locker room talk.
You should ask Anderson if he picks it up the ass.
I will.
It's about as legitimate as the question he just asked Trump.
We're going to defeat ISIS. ISIS happened a number of years ago in a vacuum that was left because of bad judgment.
Oh,
and I will tell you, I will take care of ISIS.
Mr. Trump,
we should get onto much more important things and much bigger things.
This isn't even
just for the record, though. Are you saying that what you said on that bus 11 years ago, that you did not actually kiss women without consent?
Do you take it up the ass, Anderson Cooper? I just want to know.
Women. Nobody has more respect for women than I do.
So for the record, you're saying you never did that.
Things,
yeah.
Frankly,
thank you for that opener. Gutter trash politics. Thank you, Anderson Cooper. You gave us exactly what I knew you'd give us.
But I have tremendous respect for women.
Have you ever done those things?
Have respect.
You are owned by Hillary Clinton.
You. No, I have not. And I will tell you that I'm going to
ask about Bill and his
safe.
Rapes.
We're going to have borders in our country, which we don't have now. People are pouring into our country, and they're coming in from the Middle East and other places. We're going to make America safe again. We're going to make America great again, but we're going to make America safe again. And we're going to make America wealthy again, because if you don't do that, it sounds harsh to say, but we have to build up the wealth of
our
nation right now.
Now, he better ask her about her husband raping other women next.
Thank you, Mr. Trump.
We better get that, because he just did that to Trump.
Well,
oh, you just get to respond.
Like everyone else,
oh, okay, great,
I've
wonderful.
Spent a lot of time thinking over the last 48 hours
about your rapist
about
husband.
What we heard and saw.
Juanita Broderick, you know, being raped by Bill.
Prior Republican nominees for president, I disagreed with them on politics, policies, principles, but I never questioned their fitness to serve.
Donald You've collapsed
Trump
on camera, by the way.
I said starting back in June that he was not fit to be president and commander-in-chief. And many Republicans and independents have said the same thing.
Yeah, because they're all owned by the same system.
What we all saw and heard
Romney and others
on Friday,
the Bushes,
was Donald talking about women, what he thinks about women, what he does to women. And he has said that the video doesn't represent who he is, but I think it's clear to anyone who heard it that it represents exactly who he is, because we've seen this throughout the campaign.
Can we talk about real issues here? Are we really talking about vaginas? Seriously, I told you this is going to happen. It's a vagina conversation.
On their appearance, ranking them from 1 to 10.
Should ask Hillary Clinton if she's a lesbo. Bill says she's eaten more you-know-what than anyone he knows, more than him.
We saw him after the first debate spend nearly a week.
We've seen you collapse into a van, a getaway van.
In the harshest,
have a seizure on camera.
Terms. So, yes, this is who Donald Trump is. But it's not only women, and it's not only this video that raises questions
about
his fitness to be our president. Because he has also targeted immigrants, African Americans, Latinos, people with disabilities, POWs, Muslims, and so many others. So this is who Donald Trump is. And the question for us, the question our country must answer, is that this is not who we are. That's why, to go back to your question, I want to send a message, we all should, to every boy and girl, and indeed to the entire world, that America already is great, but we are great because we are good. And we will respect one another, and we will
like your husband
work with one another, and we will celebrate our diversity. These are very important values to me, because this is the America that I know and love. And I can pledge to you tonight that this is the America that I will serve if I'm so fortunate enough to become your president.
Anderson Cooper was CIA at one point and is a Vanderbilt, if you didn't know.
I assume I am.
Yes, you can respond to that.
It's just words, folks. It's just words. Those words, I've been hearing them for many years. I heard them when they were running for the Senate in New York, where Hillary was going to bring back jobs to upstate New York, and she failed.
He's moving
I've
to
heard
the
them
issues.
Where Hillary is constantly talking about the inner cities of our country, which are a disaster, education-wise, job-wise, safety-wise, in every way possible. I'm going to help the African Americans. I'm going to help the Latinos, Hispanics. I am going to help the inner cities. She's done a terrible job for the African Americans. She wants their vote, and she does nothing. And then she comes back 4 years later We saw that firsthand when she was a United States Senator. She campaigned where the
Mr. Trump, I want to get to audience questions and online questions.
We need to talk about the vagina a little bit more, Trump. This is a PC debate here. Excuse me, Trump.
Right now.
Shut up. We got to ask you another sex question. Hold on.
Intense interest. In just 48 hours, it's become the single most
talked about story. Oh, my God. She's going to do it again.
The entire 2016 election.
You are a whore.
With millions and millions of people discussing it on the social network. As we said a moment ago, we do want to bring in questions from voters around the country via social media. And our first stays on this topic. Jeff from Ohio asks on Facebook, Trump says the campaign has changed him. When did that happen? So, Mr. Trump, let me add to that. When you walked off that bus at age 59,
yep,
were you a different man, or did that behavior continue until
still in the vagina, still
and
on
you
it.
Have 2 minutes for this.
I told you, that was
gutter
room
politics. Hillary is gutter trash.
I am a person who has great respect for people, for my family, for the people of this country, and certainly I'm not proud of it, but that was something that happened. If you look at Bill Clinton, far worse, minor words, and his was action. His was what he's done to women. There's never been anybody in the history of politics in this nation that's been so abusive to women.
Good.
So you can say any way you want to say it, but Bill Clinton was abusive to women. Hillary Clinton attacked those same women.
Mm-hmm. And intimidated them.
Attacked them viciously. Four of them here tonight. One of the women, who is a wonderful woman, at 12 years old, was raped.
I wonder how Hillary feels right now.
At 12. Her client, she represented, got him off. And she's seen laughing on two separate occasions, laughing at the girl who was raped. Kathy Shelton, that young woman, is here with us tonight. So don't tell me about words. I apologize for those words. But it is things that people say. But what President Clinton did, he was impeached. He lost his license to practice law. He had to pay an $850,000 fine to one of the women, mm-hmm. Paula Jones, who's also here tonight.
$1 million. Wow.
And I will tell you that when Hillary brings up a point like that, and she talks about words that I said 11 years ago, I think it's disgraceful, and I think she should be ashamed of herself, if you want to know the truth.
Absolutely.
Can we please hold the applause? Secretary Clinton, you have 2 minutes.
Well, first, let me start by saying that so much of what he's just said is not right, but he gets to run his campaign any way he chooses. He gets to decide what he wants to talk about. Instead of answering people's questions, talking about our agenda, laying out the plans that we have that we think can make a better life and a better country, that's his choice.
No, it's not. You
when
opened
I hear
with a question,
like
and
that,
so did CNN.
I am reminded of what my friend Michelle Obama advised us all. When they go low, you go high.
You went low. You're the one that went low. These are really opening questions.
Look.
You're the one in the gutter.
If this were just about one video, maybe what he's saying tonight would be understandable. But everyone can draw their own conclusions at this point about whether or not the man in the video or the man on the stage respects women. But he never apologizes for anything to anyone. He never apologized to Mr. and Mrs. Khan, the Gold Star family, whose son, Captain Khan, died in the line of duty in Iraq.
By the way.
And Donald
died because of your war, Hillary, that you voted
for weeks over their religion. He never apologized to the distinguished federal judge who was born in Indiana. But Donald said he couldn't be trusted to be a judge because his parents were, quote, Mexican.
Hillary's never apologized for being a criminal.
He never apologized to the reporter that he mimicked and mocked on national television and our children were watching. And he never apologized for the racist lie that President Obama was not born in the United States of America. He owes the president an apology. He owes our country an apology. And he needs to take responsibility for his actions and his words.
Well, you owe the president an apology because, as you know very well, your campaign, Sidney Blumenthal. He's another real winner that you have, and he's the one that got this started along with your campaign manager, and they were on television just 2 weeks ago, she was saying exactly that. So you really owe him an apology. Yeah. You're the one that sent the pictures around your campaign, sent the pictures around with President Obama in a certain garb. That was long before I was ever involved, so you actually owe an apology. Number two, Michelle Obama. I've gotten to see the commercials that they did on you, and I've gotten to see some of the most vicious commercials I've ever seen of Michelle Obama talking about you, Hillary. So you talk about friend. Go back and take a look at those commercials. A race where you lost, fair and square, unlike the Bernie Sanders race.
Got your ass kicked, Hillary.
You won, but not fair and square, in my opinion.
It's rigged.
And all you have to do is take a look at WikiLeaks and just see what they said about Bernie Sanders and see what Deborah Wasserman Schultz had in mind. Because Bernie Sanders, between superdelegates and Deborah Wasserman Schultz, he never had a chance. And I was so surprised to see him sign on with the devil. But when you talk about apology, I think the one that you should really be apologizing for and the thing that you should be apologizing for are the 33,000 emails that you deleted and that you acid washed. And then the two boxes of emails and other things last week that were taken from an office and are now missing. And I'll tell you what, I didn't think I'd say this, but I'm going to say it, and I hate to say it, but if I win, I am going to instruct my attorney general to get a special prosecutor to look into your situation, because there has never been so many lies, so much deception. There has never been anything like it, and we're going to have a special prosecutor.
You're going to go to jail.
When I speak, I go out and speak. The people of this country are furious. In my opinion, the people that have been long-term workers at the FBI are furious. There has never been anything like this where emails and you get a subpoena. You get a subpoena, and after getting the subpoena, you delete 33,000 emails. And then you acid wash them, or bleach them, as you would say, a very expensive process. So we're going to get a special prosecutor, and we're going to look into it, because you know what? People have been... Their lives have been destroyed for doing one-fifth of what you've done, and it's a disgrace. And honestly, you ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Secretary Trump
Clinton,
is a stud.
I want to follow up on that. I'm going to let you talk about it.
Right there.
Everything he just said is absolutely false, but I'm not surprised.
Not.
In the first debate,
and we
in the
really,
first,
the audience needs to
I
calm
told
down
people
here.
That it would be impossible to be fact-checking Donald all the time. I'd never get to talk about anything I want to do and how we're going to really make lives better
he
for people.
He owns you. Owns
so,
you right there.
Once again, go to HillaryClinton.com. We have literally Trump. You can fact-check him,
fact-check
him in real time. Last time at the first debate, we had millions of people. Fact-checking.
Don't have another
so
seizure.
We'll have millions more fact-checking.
Don't collapse
because
on stage. You must be getting nervous.
It's just awfully good that someone with the temperament of Donald Trump is not in charge of the law in our country.
Because you'd be in jail.
Secretary Clinton.
God, she is getting
bitch
slapped
the
right now.
To please talk out loud. Please do not applaud.
Yeah,
you're just
please make it a
time.
More, guys. There should
and
be a funeral
Clinton,
here.
I do want to follow
you're not allowed
emails.
To express
you
any thought
your handling
in America.
Of your emails was a mistake.
Stand
you
back up, Hillary, since you just
director,
sat down. You almost
FBI
collapsed.
FBI Director James Comey calling your handling of classified information, quote, extremely careless. The FBI said that there were 110 classified emails that were exchanged, 8 of which were top secret, and that it was possible hostile actors did gain access to those emails. You don't call that extremely careless?
Well, Martha, first let me
Good.
Say, and
Asked
I've said it before,
Good.
But I'll repeat it because I want everyone to hear it.
I'll repeat
that
it.
Was
I'll
a
try
mistake,
not to have a seizure.
And I take responsibility for using a personal email account.
Good. So you should be in jail. You've admitted it. That's
I
great.
If I were to do
Thank
it
you.
Over again, I would not. I'm not making any excuses.
Yes, you
it
are.
It was a mistake. And I am very
an illegal
sorry
mistake.
About that.
And when
but
you make
I think it's also
commit a crime, you go to jail.
That's
great.
To point out
Thanks.
Where... There are some misleading accusations from critics
Not
and
really.
Others. After a year-long investigation, there is no evidence that anyone hacked the server I was using, and there is no evidence that
yeah, right.
anyone can point to at all Anyone who says otherwise has
no
basis.
The NSA has your emails, by the way.
Any classified material ended up in the wrong hands. I take classified materials very seriously. And always have when I was on the Senate Armed Services Committee. I was privy to a lot of classified material. Obviously, as Secretary of State, I had some of the most important secrets that we possess, such as going after bin Laden. So I am very committed to taking classified information seriously. And as I said, there is no evidence that any classified information ended up in the wrong hands.
There's a lot of evidence.
And yet, she didn't know the word, the letter C on a document.
No.
Right? She didn't even know what that word, what that letter meant. You know, it's amazing. I'm watching Hillary go over facts, and she's going after fact after fact.
She's going to have to fact check you.
Because she said she, you know, what she did with the emails was fine. You think it was fine to delete 33,000 emails? I don't think so. She said the 33,000 emails had to do with her daughter's wedding, number one, and a yoga class. Well, maybe we'll give three or four or five or something. 33,000 emails deleted. And now she's saying there wasn't anything wrong. And more importantly, that was after getting a subpoena. That wasn't before. That was after. She got it from the United States Congress. And I'll be honest, I am so disappointed in congressmen, including Republicans, for allowing this to happen. Our Justice Department, where her husband goes onto the back of an airplane for 39 minutes, talks to the Attorney General days before a ruling is going to be made on her case.
And here in Phoenix, by the way,
that there was nothing wrong with you deleting 39,000 emails. Again, you should be ashamed of yourself. What you did, and this is after getting a subpoena from the United States Congress.
We have to move on. Secretary Clinton,
I've got to interrupt you, Trump.
We want to give the audience a chance here.
You'd be put in jail, let alone after getting a subpoena from the United States Congress.
Secretary Clinton, you can respond, then we have to move on to an audience question.
Look, it's just not true, and so
yes,
please go.
Oh, you didn't delete them?
Allow her to respond, please.
Personal emails, not official.
33,000?
Well, we turned over 35,000, so it was.
What about the other 15,000?
Please allow her to respond. She didn't talk while you talked.
Let her speak, Trump.
Yes, that's true. I didn't.
Because
I didn't in the first debate, and I'm going
to
try not to in this debate, because I'd like to get to the questions that the people have brought here tonight to talk to us about.
Like vaginas. Thanks for structuring those questions from question one.
Okay, Donald, I know you're into big diversion tonight, anything to avoid talking about your campaign and the way it's exploding and the way Republicans are leaving.
Exploding?
You.
Yeah, higher.
Let's see what happens.
Imploding would be the right word. And fact-checking versus fact-checking.
Care about tonight. Let's get to their question.
We have a question here from Ken Karpowitz.
Wow, she's getting owned. Owned.
I'd like to know, Anderson, why aren't you bringing up the emails? I'd like to know. Why aren't you
getting
to the
bottom?
No, it hasn't. It hasn't. And it hasn't been finished at all.
Ken Karpowitz has a question.
It's nice to one on three.
Thank you. Affordable Care Act, known as Obamacare, it is not affordable. Premiums have gone up, deductibles have gone up, co-pays have gone up, prescriptions have gone up, and the coverage has gone down. What will you do to bring the costs down and make coverage better?
That first one goes to Secretary Clinton, because you started out the last one to the audience.
He wants to start, he can start. No, go ahead, Donald.
No, I'm a gentleman, Hillary. Go ahead.
Secretary Clinton?
That was awesome.
Well, I think Donald was about to say he's going to solve it by repealing it and getting rid of the Affordable Care Act. And I'm going to fix it, because I agree with you. Premiums have gotten too high, copays, deductibles, prescription drug costs. And I've laid out a series of actions that we can take to try to get those costs down. But here's what I don't want people to forget when we're talking about reining in the costs, which has to be the highest priority of the next president. When the Affordable Care Act passed, it wasn't just that 20 million people got insurance who didn't have it before, but that in and of itself was a good thing. I meet these people all the time, and they tell me what a difference having that insurance meant to them and their families. But everybody else,
the
170 million of us, who get health insurance through our employers, got big benefits. Number one, insurance companies can't deny you coverage because of a pre-existing condition. Number two, no lifetime limits, which is a big deal if you have serious health problems. Number three, women can't be charged more than men for our health insurance, which is the way it used to be before the Affordable Care Act. Number four, if you're under 26 and your parents have a policy, you can be on that policy until the age of 26, something that didn't happen before. So I want very much to save what works and is good about the Affordable Care Act. But we've got to get costs down. We've got to provide some additional help to small businesses so that they can afford to provide health insurance. But if we repeal it, as Donald has proposed, and start over again, all of those benefits I just mentioned are lost to everybody, not just people who get their health insurance on the exchange. And then we would have to start all over again. Right now, we are at 90% health insurance coverage. That's the highest we've ever been in our country.
Secretary Clinton,
so I want us
up.
To get to 100%, but get costs down and keep quality up.
Mr. Trump, you have 2 minutes.
It is such a great question, and it's maybe the question I get almost more than anything else.
Is audiovisual still good for you guys? Give me a thumbs.
Obamacare is a disaster. You know it. We all know it. It's going up at numbers that nobody's ever seen worldwide. Nobody's ever seen numbers like this for health care. It's only getting worse. In 17, it implodes by itself. Their method of fixing it is to go back and ask Congress for more money, more and more money. We have right now almost $20 trillion in debt. Obamacare will never work. It's very bad health insurance. Far too expensive, and not only expensive for the person that has it, unbelievably expensive for our country. It's going to be one of the biggest line items very shortly. We have to repeal it and replace it with something absolutely much less expensive and something that works, where your plan can actually be tailored. We have to get rid of the lines around the state, artificial lines, where we stop insurance companies from coming in and competing, because they wanted President Obama and whoever was working on it, they want to leave those lines because that gives the insurance companies essentially monopolies. We want competition. You will have the finest health care plan there is. She wants to go to a single-payer plan, which would be a disaster, somewhat similar to Canada. And if you ever notice, the Canadians, when they need a big operation, when something happens, they come into the United States in many cases, because their system is so slow, it's catastrophic in certain ways. But she wants to go to single payer, which means the government basically rules everything.
Hillary
Clinton has been after this for years. Obamacare was the first step. Obamacare is a total disaster. And not only are your rates going up by numbers that nobody's ever believed, but your deductibles are going up, so that unless you get hit by a truck, you're never going to be able to use it.
Mr. Trump,
it is a disastrous plan, and it has to be repealed and replaced.
Secretary Clinton, let me follow up with you. Your husband called Obamacare, quote, the craziest thing in the world, saying that small business owners are getting killed as premiums double, coverage is cut in half. Was he mistaken, or was his mistake simply telling the truth?
No, I mean, he clarified what he meant, and it's very clear. Look, we are in a situation in our country where if we were to start all
Bill
over
Clinton
again,
said that intentionally too,
we might
way.
Come up with a different system. But we have an employer-based system. That's where the vast majority of people get their health care. And the Affordable Care Act was meant to try to fill the gap between people who were too poor and couldn't put together any resources to afford health care, namely people on Medicaid. Obviously, Medicare, which is a single-payer system, which takes care of our elderly and does a great job doing it, by the way. And then all the people who were employed, but people who were working but didn't have the money to afford insurance and didn't have anybody, an employer or anybody else, to help them. That was the slot that the Obamacare approach was to take. And like I say, 20 million people now have health insurance. So if we just rip it up and throw it away, what Donald's not telling you is we just turn it back to the insurance companies the way it used to be. And that means the insurance companies get to do pretty much whatever they want, including saying, look, I'm sorry, you've got diabetes, you had cancer, your child has asthma.
Your time is up.
You may not be able to have insurance because you can't afford it. So let's fix what's broken about it, but let's not throw it away and give it all back to the insurance companies and
let
the
me follow
companies.
Up with you, Mr.
That's not going to work.
Mr. Trump, let me follow up
well,
on this.
I just want to just one thing. First of all, Hillary, everything's broken about it, everything. Number two, Bernie Sanders said that Hillary Clinton has very bad judgment. This is a perfect example of it, trying
Trump,
to save Obamacare, which is...
You've said you want to end Obamacare. You've said you want to end Obamacare. You've also said you want to make coverage accessible for people with pre-existing conditions. How do you force insurance companies to do that if you're no longer mandating that every
We're
American get insurance?
We're going to be able to. You're going to have plans.
What does that mean?
Well, I'll tell you what it means. You're going to have plans that are so good because we're going to have so much competition in the insurance industry once we break out the lines and allow the competition to come.
Are you going to have a mandate that Americans
Anderson,
have to have health insurance?
Me. President Obama, by keeping those lines, the boundary lines around each state, and it was almost gone until just very toward the end of the passage of Obamacare, which, by the way, was a fraud. You know that. Because Jonathan Gruber, the architect of Obamacare, said it was a great lie. It was a big lie. President Obama said, you keep your doctor, you keep your plan. The whole thing was a fraud, and it doesn't work. But when we get rid of those lines, you have competition, and we will be able to keep pre-existing. We'll also be able to help people that don't have money, because we are going to have people protected. And Republicans feel this way, believe it or not, and strongly this way. We're going to block grant into the states. We're going to block grant into Medicaid into
Thank
the
you,
states
Mr. Trump.
So that we will be able to take care of people without the necessary funds to take care of themselves.
Thank you, Mr. Trump.
We now go to Gorba Hamid with a question for both candidates.
Hi. There are 3.3 million Muslims in the United States, and I'm one of them. You've mentioned working with Muslim nations, but with Islamophobia on the rise, how will you help people like me deal with the consequences of being labeled as a threat to the country after the election is over?
Mr. Trump, you're first.
Well, you're right about Islamophobia, and that's a shame. But one thing we have to do is we have to make sure that, because there is a problem.
Yeah,
I mean, whether we like it or not, and we can be very politically correct, but whether we like it or not, there is a problem. And we have to be sure that Muslims come in and report when they see something going on. When they see hatred going on, they have to report it. As an example, in San Bernardino, many people saw the bombs all over the apartment of the two people that killed 14 and wounded many, many people. Horribly wounded. They'll never be the same. Muslims have to report the problems when they see
Notice
them.
Notice how Hillary has to sit
and,
down right now?
You know, there's always a reason for everything.
Looks
if they
really
don't
bad,
do that, it's a very difficult situation for our country. Because
Outfit
you look at Orlando, and you look at San Bernardino, and you look at
the
World
ridiculous.
Trade Center. Go outside, you look at Paris. Look at that horrible. These are radical Islamic terrorists. And she won't even mention the word, and nor will President Obama. He won't use the term radical Islamic terrorism. Now, to solve a problem, you have to be able to state what the problem is, or at least say the name. She won't say the name, and President Obama won't say the name, but the name is there. It's radical Islamic terror. And before you solve it, you have to say the name.
Secretary Clinton.
Well, thank you for asking your question. And I've heard this question from a lot of Muslim Americans across our country, because unfortunately, there's been a lot of very divisive, dark things said about Muslims. And even someone like Captain Khan, the young man who sacrificed himself defending our country
nothing,
in the United States Army, has been subject to attack by Donald.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I want to say just a couple of things.
All.
First, we've had Muslims in America since George Washington. And we've had many successful Muslims. We just lost a particularly well-known one with Muhammad Ali. My vision of America is an America where everyone has a place. Mm-hmm. If you're willing to work hard, you do your part,
Does
you
it
contribute
include radical
to the community.
Jihadists?
That's what America is. That's what we want America to be for our children and our grandchildren. It's also very short-sighted and even dangerous to be engaging in the kind of demagogic rhetoric that Donald has about
there
Muslims.
There she goes again. She's going to attack Donald.
We need American Muslims to be part of our eyes and ears on our front lines. I've worked with a lot of different Muslim groups around America. I've met with a lot of them, and I've heard how important it is for them to feel that they are wanted and included and part of our country, part of our homeland security. And that's what I want to see. It's also important, I intend to defeat ISIS, to do so in a coalition with majority Muslim nations.
You've armed it and funded it.
Right now, a lot of those nations are hearing what Donald says and wondering,
by the way,
why should we cooperate with the Americans? And this is a gift to ISIS and the terrorists. Violent, jihadist terrorists. We are not at war with Islam. And it is a mistake, and it plays into the hands of the terrorists to act as though we are. So I want a country where citizens like you and your family are just as welcome as anyone else.
Yeah, as long as you're not a radical jihadi terrorist.
Mr. Trump, in December, you said this. Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States until our country's representatives can figure out what the hell is going on. We have no choice. We have no choice. Your running mate said this week that the Muslim ban is no longer your position. Is that correct? And if it is, was it a mistake to have a religious test?
First of all, Captain Khan is an American hero. And if I were president at that time, he would be alive today. Because unlike her, who voted for the war without knowing what she was doing,
something
I would
said.
Not have had our people in Iraq.
He
Iraq was a
Hillary.
Disaster. So he would have been alive today. The Muslim ban is something that in some form has morphed into a extreme vetting from certain areas of the world. Hillary Clinton wants to allow
and why did
thousands,
it morph into that?
Me,
no, did you no answer the question.
Why
do you,
you
still believe
her?
You I
do me all the time. Why don't you
Would
interrupt
you
her?
Please explain
she works
whether
for
or not the Muslim ban still stands.
It's called extreme vetting. We are going to areas like Syria where they're coming in by the tens of thousands because of Barack Obama, and Hillary Clinton wants to allow a 550% increase over Obama. People are coming into our country like we have no idea who they are, where they're from, what their feelings about our country is, and she wants 550% more. This is going to be the great Trojan horse of all time. We have enough problems in this country.
Well,
I believe in building safe zones. I believe in having other people pay for them. As an example, the Gulf states who are not carrying their weight, but they have nothing but money, and take care of people. But I don't want to have, with all the problems this country has and all of the problems that you see going on, hundreds of thousands of people coming in from Syria when we know nothing about them. We know nothing about their values, and we know nothing about their love for our country.
And Secretary Clinton, let me ask you about that. Because you have asked for an increase from 10 to 65,000 Syrian refugees. We know you want tougher vetting. That's not a perfect system. So why take the risk of having those refugees come into the country?
Well, first of all, I will not let anyone into our country that I think poses a risk to us. But there are a lot of refugees, women and children. Think of that picture we all saw of that four-year-old boy
with
the blood on his forehead because he'd been bombed by the Russian and Syrian air forces.
Because of you, you've destabilized the Middle East, Hillary.
Suffering in this catastrophic war, largely, I believe, because of Russian aggression.
You created the death.
And we need to do our part. We by no means are carrying anywhere near the load that Europe and others are. But we will have vetting that is as tough as it needs to be from our professionals, our intelligence experts, and others. But it is important for us as a policy, not to say, as Donald has said, we're going to ban people based on a religion. How do you do that? We are a country founded on religious freedom.
He said he's
going to
ban radicals, terrorists, from entering the country.
Do what he has
he's
advocated
not banning religion.
Without causing
There's
great distress within our own country. Are we going to have religious tests when people fly into our country? And how do we expect to be able to implement those? So I thought that what he said was extremely unwise and even dangerous. And indeed, you can look at the propaganda on a lot of the terrorist sites. And what Donald Trump says about Muslims
like CNN.
Is used to recruit fighters because they want to create a war between us. And the final thing I would say, this is the 10th or 12th time that he's denied being for the war in Iraq.
Someone in the audience.
We have it on tape. The entire press corps has looked at it. It's been debunked, but it never stops him from saying whatever he wants
has
to say.
Has not been debunked.
No,
so
it has not been debunked.
Been debunked.
Go to HillaryClinton.com and you can see it.
Yeah, you can fact check in America.
It has not been debunked. And you voted for it, and you shouldn't have.
Well, yeah, absolutely.
There's been lots of fact-checking on that. I'd like to move on to an online question.
She just went about 25 seconds over her time.
She
could I just respond to this, please?
Very quickly, please.
Hillary Clinton, in terms of having people come into our country, we have many criminal illegal aliens. When we want to send them back to their country says, we don't want them. In some cases, they're murderers, drug lords, drug problems, and they don't want them. And Hillary Clinton, when she was Secretary of State, said, that's okay, we can't force it into their country. Let me tell you, I'm going to force them right back into their country. They're murderers and some very bad people. And I will tell you very strongly, when Bernie Sanders said she had bad judgment, she has really bad judgment, because we are letting people into this country that are going to cause problems and crime like you've never seen. We're also letting drugs pour through our southern border at a record clip, and it shouldn't be allowed to happen. ICE just endorsed me. They've never endorsed a presidential candidate. The Border Patrol agents, 16,500, just recently endorsed me. And they endorsed me because I understand the border. She doesn't. She wants amnesty for everybody. Come right in. Come right over. Mm-hmm. It's a horrible thing she's doing. She's got bad judgment, and honestly, so bad that she should never be president of the United States. That I can tell you.
Thank you, Mr. Trump. I want to move on. This next question comes from the public through the Bipartisan Open Debate Coalition's online forum, where Americans submitted questions that generated millions of votes. This question involves WikiLeaks' release of purported excerpts of Secretary Clinton's paid speeches, which she has refused to release, and one line in particular in which you, Secretary Clinton, purportedly say you need both a public and private position on certain issues. So, two from Virginia asks, is it okay for politicians to be two-faced? Is it acceptable for a politician to have a private stance on issues? Secretary Clinton, your 2 minutes.
Right. As I recall, that was something I said about Abraham Lincoln after
Mr.
having
Rector.
Seen the wonderful Steven Spielberg movie called Lincoln. It was a master class watching President Lincoln get the Congress to approve the 13th Amendment. It was principled and it was strategic. And I was making the point that it is hard sometimes to get the Congress to do what you want to do, and you have to keep working at it. And yes, President Lincoln was trying to convince some people. He used some arguments.
Not answering the question
convincing
at all.
Other
You're
people. He used other arguments.
Over to Abraham
that
Lincoln.
Was a great, I thought, a great display of presidential leadership. But, you know, let's talk about what's really going on here, Martha, because our intelligence community just came out and said in the last few days that the Kremlin, meaning Putin and the Russian government, are directing the attacks, the hacking on American accounts to influence our election. And WikiLeaks is part of that, as are other sites where the Russians hack information. We don't even know if it's accurate information, and then they put it out. We have never in the history of our country been in a situation where an adversary, a foreign power, is working so hard to influence the outcome of the election. And believe me, they're not doing it to get me elected. They're doing it to try to influence the election for Donald Trump. Now, maybe because he has praised Putin, maybe because he says he agrees with a lot of what Putin wants to do, maybe because he wants to do business in Moscow. I don't know the reasons. But we deserve answers, and we should demand that Donald release all of his tax returns so that people can see what
misdirection,
the entanglements and the financial relationships.
We're going to get to that later.
She just doesn't even answer the question, man.
Well, I think I should respond,
Trump,
because it's so ridiculous.
Yeah, it is.
Look, now she's blaming. She got caught in a total lie. Her papers went out to all her friends at the banks, Goldman Sachs and everybody else. And she said things, WikiLeaks, that just came out.
And she lied. Now she's blaming the lie on the late, great Abraham Lincoln.
That's exactly. One that That's desecrating Lincoln, man.
Okay,
wow.
Honest Abe. Honest Abe never lied. That's the good thing. That's the big difference between Abraham Lincoln and you. That's a big, big difference. We're talking about some difference.
Yeah, huge. But huge.
As far
Happy
as
the frog just showed up.
Other elements of what she was saying, I don't know, Putin. I think it would be great if we got along with Russia because we could fight ISIS together as an example. But I don't know, Putin.
Yeah, and there wouldn't be a nuclear
But I notice
war,
anytime anything
hopefully.
Wrong happens, they like to say, the Russians, the Russians. She doesn't know if it's the Russians doing the hacking. Maybe there is no hacking. But they always blame Russia. And the reason they blame Russia is because they think they're trying to tarnish me with Russia. I know nothing about Russia. I know about Russia, but I know nothing about the inner workings of Russia. I don't deal there. I have no businesses there. I have no loans from Russia. I have a very, very great balance sheet. So great that when I did the old post office on Pennsylvania Avenue, the United States government, because of my balance sheet, which they actually know very well, chose me to do the old post office between the White House and Congress, chose me to do the old post office. One of the primary things, in fact, perhaps the primary thing, was balance sheet. But I have no loans with Russia. You could go to the United States government and they would probably tell you that because they know my sheet very well in order to get that development I had to have. Now, the taxes are a very simple thing. As soon as I have, first of all, I pay hundreds of millions of dollars in taxes. Many of our friends took bigger deductions. Warren Buffett took a massive deduction. Mm-hmm. Soros, who's a friend of hers, took a massive deduction. Many of the people that are giving her all this money that she can do many more commercials than me gave her, took massive deductions. I pay hundreds of millions of dollars in taxes. But as soon as my routine audit's finished, I'll release my returns. I'll be very proud to.
They're Thank actually you, Mr. Trump. Great.
We've got a, we're on turn, actually, the topic of taxes. We have a question from Spencer Moss. Spencer?
Good evening. My question is, what specific tax provisions will you change to ensure the wealthiest Americans pay their fair share in taxes?
Mr. Trump, you have 2 minutes.
Well, one thing I do is get rid of carried interest. One of the greatest provisions for people like me, to be honest with you, I give up a lot when I run because I knock out the tax code. And she could have done this years ago, by the way. She was a United States senator. She complains that Donald Trump took advantage of the tax code. Well, why didn't she change it? Why didn't you change it when you were a senator? The reason you didn't is that all your friends take the same advantage that I do. And I do. Yeah, you have provisions in the tax code that, frankly, we could change. But you wouldn't change it because all of these people give you the money so you can take negative ads on Donald Trump. But, and I say that about a lot of things. You know, I've heard Hillary complaining about so many different things over the years. I wish you'd have done this. But she's been there for 30 years. She's been doing this stuff. She never changed, and she never will change. She never will change. We're getting rid of carried interest provisions. I'm lowering taxes, actually, because I think it's so important for corporations, because we have corporations leaving, massive corporations and little ones. Little ones can't form. We're getting rid of regulations, which goes hand in hand with the lowering of the taxes. But we're bringing the tax rate down from 35% to 15%. We're cutting taxes for the middle class, and I will tell you, we are cutting them big league for the middle class. And I will tell you, Hillary Clinton is raising your taxes, folks. You can look at me. She's raising your taxes really high. And what that's going to do is a disaster for the country. But she is raising your taxes, and I'm lowering your taxes. That in itself is a big difference. We are going to be thriving again.
Reinvestment,
we have no growth
businesses.
In this country. There's no growth. If
Creates
China
growth.
Has a GDP of 7%, it's like a national catastrophe. We're down at 1%. And that's like no growth. And we're going lower, in my opinion. And a lot of it has to do with the fact that our taxes are so high, just about the highest in the world. Mm-hmm. And I'm bringing them down to one of the lower in the world. And I think it's so important, one of the most important things we can do. But she is raising everybody's taxes massively.
Secretary Clinton, you have 2 minutes. The question was, what specific tax provisions will you change to ensure the wealthiest Americans pay their fair share of taxes?
Raise taxes. What should
well, everything you've heard just now from Donald is not true. I'm sorry I have to keep saying this, but he lives in an alternative reality.
No, he
and
doesn't.
It is
you do.
Sort of amusing to hear somebody who hasn't paid federal income taxes in maybe 20 years talking about what he's going to do, but I'll tell you what he's going to do. His plan will give the wealthy and corporations the biggest tax cuts they've ever had, more than the Bush tax cuts by at least a factor of two. Donald always takes care of Donald and people like Donald, and this would be a massive gift. And indeed, the way that he talks about his tax cuts would end up raising taxes on middle-class families, millions of middle-class families. Now, here's what I want to do. I have said nobody who makes less than $250,000 a year, and that's the vast majority of Americans, as you know, will have their taxes raised, because I think we've got to go where the money is, and the money is with people who've taken advantage of every single break in the tax code. And yes, when I was a senator, I did vote to close corporate loopholes. I voted to close, I think, one of the loopholes he took advantage of when he claimed $1 billion loss that enabled him to avoid paying taxes. I want to have a tax on people.
Apple does the same thing.
It's called the Buffett rule. Yes, Warren Buffett is the one who's gone out and said somebody like him should not be paying a lower tax rate than his secretary.
Because Buffett is a whore to Barack Obama and you and the New World Order establishment.
We have to make up for lost times. Because I want to invest in you. I want to invest in hardworking families. And I think it's been unfortunate, but it's happened that since the Great Recession, the gains have all gone to the top.
That's stealing.
And we need to reverse that. People like Donald, who paid zero in taxes, zero for our vets, zero for our military, zero for health and education, that is wrong. And we're going to make sure that nobody, no corporation and no individual, can get away without paying.
Funneling hundreds of millions of dollars to the Clinton Foundation is wrong.
Mr. Trump, I want to give the chance to respond. I just want to tell our viewers what she's referring to.
The
last month, taxes were the number one issue on Facebook for the first time in the campaign. The New York Times published three pages of your 1995 tax returns. They show you claimed a $916 million loss, which means you could have avoided paying personal federal income taxes for years. You've said you pay state taxes, employee taxes, real estate taxes, property taxes. You have not answered, though, a simple question. Did you use that $916 million loss to avoid paying personal federal income taxes for
years? Of course I do.
Yeah,
of course I do.
It's legal to do that. That's smart.
Donors. I know many of her donors. Her donors took massive tax write-offs.
Exactly.
A lot of my write-off was depreciation and other things that Hillary, as a senator, allowed. And she'll always allow it because the people that give her all this money, they want it.
Yeah, that's why. A money whore.
See, I understand the tax code better than anybody that's ever run for president. Hillary Clinton, and it's extremely complex, Hillary Clinton has friends that want all of these provisions, including they want the carried interest provision, which is very important to Wall Street people, but they really want the carried interest provision, which I believe Hillary's leaving. It's very interesting why she's leaving carried interest. But I will tell you that, number one, I pay tremendous numbers of taxes. I absolutely used it, and so did Warren Buffett, and so did George Soros, and so did many of the other people that Hillary is getting money from. I won't mention their names because they're rich, but they're not famous, so we won't make them famous.
Okay? Can you say how many years you have avoided paying personal federal income taxes?
No, but I pay tax, and I pay federal tax, too. But I have a write-off. A lot of it's depreciation, which is a wonderful charge. I love depreciation. You know, she's given it to us. Hey, if she had a problem, for 30 years she's been doing this, Anderson, I say it all the time. She talks about health care. Why didn't she do something about it? She talks about taxes. Why didn't she do something about it? She doesn't do anything about anything other than talk. With her, it's all talk and no action.
In the past,
and again,
just like on gay, she was anti-gay before,
it's
now she's
really
pro-gay.
Bad judgment. She has made bad judgment not only on taxes, she's made bad judgments on Libya, on Syria, on Iraq. I mean, her and Obama, whether you like it or not, the way they got out of Iraq, the vacuum they've left, that's why ISIS formed in the first place. They started
absolutely
from that little area,
correct,
and now they're in 32 different nations, Hillary.
And killing
so congratulations.
Americans.
Great job.
Once you be able to respond.
Yeah, great job, Hillary. Great job.
Well, here we go again.
Oh, she might have a seizure.
In favor of
might
getting
collapse.
Rid of carried interest for years.
But you didn't.
When I was a
over 30 years,
from
you didn't.
New York.
So,
but
that's
not the point here.
Why didn't you do it? Why didn't you?
Yeah,
do
why
it?
Not? You had 30 years to do it.
Because I was with a Republican president.
Oh, really?
I will be the
you
president.
You could have done it if you were an effective. If you were
exactly
an effective
right.
senator, you could have done it. If you were an effective senator, you could have done it. But you were not an effective.
Please allow her
senator.
To respond. She didn't interrupt you.
You know, under our Constitution, presidents have something called veto power. Look. He has now
said supposed to be cute? Are you kidding me?
30 years this and 30
awkward.
Years that. So let me talk about my 30 years in public service. I'm very glad to do so.
Yeah, your 30-year criminal track record.
8 million kids every year have health insurance because when I was first lady, I worked with Democrats and Republicans to create the Children's Health Insurance Program.
Let's bring up the kids. It's all about the children.
Hundreds of thousands of kids now have a chance to be adopted because I worked to change our adoption and foster care system.
How is this relevant?
After 9/11, I went to work with Republican mayor, governor, and president to rebuild New York and to get health care for our first responders who were suffering because they had run toward danger and gotten sickened by it. Hundreds of thousands of National Guard and Reserve members have health care because of work that I did. And children have safer medicines because I was able to pass a law that required the dosing to be more carefully done. When I was Secretary of State, I went around the world advocating for our country, but also advocating for women's rights to make sure that women had
there's the vagina card again. All
chance
about the vagina.
To have a
the
better life
question.
And negotiated a treaty with Russia to lower nuclear weapons. 400 pieces of legislation have my name on it as a sponsor or co-sponsor
like what,
when
Bankster
I was
bailouts?
Senator for 8 years.
Why don't you mention that?
TARP? I worked very hard name on it? And yep. was very proud to be reelected in New York by an even bigger margin than I had been elected the first time. And as president, I will take that work, that bipartisan work, that finding common ground, because you have to be able to get along with people to get things done in Washington.
Thank you, Secretary.
And I've proven that I can. And for 30 years, I've produced results for
people.
Thank
you, Secretary.
We're going to move on to Syria. Both
Trump's
of you have
really
mentioned that.
Too. It's good.
A lot of things. I think we should
we can,
be allowed
no,
to maybe
Mr. Trump, we're going to go on. This is
she
about
has
the audience.
Disaster as a
Mr.
Senator.
Trump,
a
we're
disaster.
Going to move on.
Mm-hmm. We don't want you
the
to respond,
The heartbreaking
Trump.
Video of a 5-year-old Syrian boy named Amran sitting in an ambulance after being pulled from the
total
rubble,
propaganda
rubble
and created
after
by
an airstrike in Aleppo
Clinton. Hillary
focused the world's attention on the horrors of the war in Syria with 136
How about the U.S. government bombing a Doctors Without Borders
Facebook
hospital
alone.
And murdering innocent children?
But there
children.
Are much worse images coming out of Aleppo every day now where in the past
yeah,
few weeks
because
alone,
of her sitting down there,
people
the great
have been
Satan.
Killed at least 100 of them children. Just days ago, the State Department called for a war crimes investigation of the Syrian regime of Bashar al-Assad and its ally, Russia, for their bombardment of Aleppo. So this next question comes from social media through Facebook. Diane from Pennsylvania asks, if you were president, what would you do about Syria and the humanitarian crisis in Aleppo? Isn't it a lot like
well,
the
Hillary's
going to
take out Assad,
because
that's always been the intent.
Too long
just like they
before we help.
Killed
Secretary
Muammar Gaddafi.
Clinton, we will begin with your two
so that's
minutes.
The agenda. Take them out
well,
and stabilize rightful sovereign governments.
Well, the situation in Syria is catastrophic.
Yeah, because
and
of you.
Every day that goes by, we see the results of the regime by
the
Assad
government, not a
in
regime.
Partnership with the
government.
Iranians on the ground, the Russians in the air.
But you negotiate with the Iranians.
Bombarding places, in particular Aleppo, where they're are hundreds of thousands of people, probably about 250,000 still left. And there is a determined effort by the Russian Air Force to destroy Aleppo in order to
they're defending an ally,
eliminate
which you've been destabilizing.
The last of the Syrian rebels
like
who were really holding
Canada.
Out against the Assad regime. Russia hasn't paid any attention to ISIS. They're interested in keeping Assad in power.
Yeah, exactly.
So
he's an
I,
ally.
When I was Secretary of State, advocated and I advocate today a no-fly zone and safe zones.
Which will
we need
create
some
world
leverage
war.
With
there
the
there will
Russians,
be nukes going off with a no-fly
because
zone.
They're not going to
that's what Hillary
come
wants.
To
she
the
just told you.
Negotiating
world
table
war.
For a diplomatic
right there. No-fly zone, man. You're gonna
resolution
have.
Unless
act.
There is some leverage over them.
That's what she wants.
And we have to work more closely with our partners and allies on the ground.
You're ISIS, your ally that you created,
that
arming and funding them, that's declassified now, fact.
Is the ambitions and the aggressiveness of Russia. Russia has decided that it's all in Syria, and they've also decided who they want to see become president of the United States, too, and it's not me. I've stood up to Russia.
It's not you.
I've taken on Putin and others.
You want to create war.
And I would do that as president. I think wherever we can cooperate with Russia, that's fine. And I did as Secretary of State. That's how we got a treaty reducing nuclear weapons. It's how we got the sanctions on Iran that put a lid on the Iranian nuclear program without firing a single shot. So I would go to the negotiating table with more leverage than we have now. Mm-hmm. But I do support the effort to investigate for crimes, war crimes, committed by the Assyrians and the Russians and try to hold them accountable.
To investigate the crimes that you've committed.
Was there a Secretary of State with the so-called line in the sand, which...
No, I wasn't. I was gone. I hate to interrupt you, but...
But you were in contact, excuse me.
At some point, we
you're interrupting.
You were in total contact with the White House.
Shut up.
And perhaps...
And sit down
sadly,
before you
Obama
have another seizure.
Probably still listened to you. I don't think he'd be listening to you very much anymore. Obama draws the line in the sand. It was laughed at all over the world what happened. Now, with that being said, she talks tough against Russia. But our nuclear program has fallen way behind, and they've gone wild with their nuclear program. Not good.
Yep.
Our government shouldn't have allowed that to happen. Russia is new in terms of nuclear. We are old. We're tired. We're exhausted in terms of nuclear. A very bad thing. Now, she talks tough. She talks really tough against Putin and against Assad. She talks in favor of the rebels. She doesn't even know who the rebels are. You know, every time we take rebels, whether it's in Iraq or anywhere else, we're arming people. And you know what happens? They end up being worse than the people. Look at what she did in Libya with Gaddafi.
Mm-hmm. Gaddafi's
out. It's a mess. And by the way, ISIS has a good chunk of their oil. I'm sure you probably have heard that.
Weaponry,
it was a disaster.
Heavy artillery,
because the fact
tanks,
is, almost everything
trucks,
she's done in foreign policy has been a mistake, and it's been a disaster. But if you look at Russia, just take a look at Russia, and look at what they did this week, where I agree she wasn't there, but possibly she's consulted. We sign a peace treaty. Everyone's all excited. Well, what Russia did with Assad, and by the way, with Iran, who you made very powerful with the dumbest deal perhaps I've ever seen in the history of deal-making, the Iran deal with $150 billion, with the $1.7 billion in cash, which is enough cash to fill up this room. But look at that deal. Iran now and Russia are now against us. So she wants to fight. She wants to fight for rebels. There's only one problem. You don't even know who the rebels are.
Mr. Trump,
so
Mr.
What's
Trump,
the purpose?
You're 2 minutes
And one thing
up.
I have to say,
you're 2 minutes
I don't like
up.
Assad at all, but Assad is killing ISIS. Russia is killing ISIS, and Iran is killing ISIS. And those three have now lined up because of our weak foreign policy.
Absolutely.
Mr. Trump, let me repeat the question. If you were president, what would you do about Syria and the humanitarian crisis in Aleppo? And I want
Take
to remind
ISIS.
You what your running mate said.
That Hillary
he said
created,
provocations by Russia need to be met with American strength, and that if Russia continues to be involved in airstrikes along with the Syrian government forces of Assad, the United States of America should be prepared to use military force to strike the military targets of the Assad regime.
Okay. He and I haven't spoken, and I disagree. I disagree.
You disagree with your running mate.
I think we have to knock out ISIS. Right now, Syria is fighting ISIS. We have people that want to fight both at the same time. But Syria is no longer Syria. Syria is Russia, and it's Iran, who she made strong, and Kerry and Obama made into a very powerful nation and a very rich nation very, very quickly, very, very quickly.
Thank you very much.
I believe we have to get ISIS. We have to worry about ISIS before we can get too much more involved. She had a chance to do something with Syria. They had a chance. And that was the line.
What do you think will happen if Aleppo falls?
I think Aleppo is a disaster humanitarian-wise.
What do you think will happen if it falls?
Well, that's what Hillary wants.
I think that it basically has fallen, okay? It basically has fallen. Let me tell you something. You take a look at Mosul. The biggest problem I have with the stupidity of our foreign policy. We have Mosul. They think a lot of the ISIS leaders are in Mosul. So we have announcements coming out of Washington and coming out of Iraq.
Yeah, they telegraph
we will
it.
Be attacking Mosul in three yeah, weeks
get
or four
out, run
weeks.
For your lives.
Well, all of these bad leaders from ISIS are leaving Mosul. Why can't they do it quietly? Why can't they do the attack, make it a
because
sneak
they don't
attack,
want to take out ISIS.
And
they
after
want
the attack is made,
the fire at ISIS.
Inform the American public that we've knocked out the leaders, we've had a tremendous success. People leave. Why do they have to say we're going to be attacking Mosul within the next 4 to 6 weeks, which is what they're saying? How stupid is our country?
There are sometimes reasons the military does that. Psychological warfare.
I can't
warfare.
Think of any. I can't think of any.
She defends
it.
Aren't you a journalist?
And we have, look, I have 200 generals and admirals who endorse me. I have 21 Congressional Medal of Honor recipients who endorse me. We talk about it all the time. They understand. Why can't they do something secretively where they go in and they knock out the leadership? Why would these people stay there? I've been reading now
for
weeks.
Tell me what your strategy is.
I've been reading now for weeks about Mosul.
What is this?
It's the harbor of where, you know, between Raqqa and Mosul. This is where they think the ISIS leaders are.
The journalist is attacking Trump. I thought she's supposed to be impartial.
Because everybody's
I'm not a journalist. I'm a media pundit and a media personality. I have an opinion. She's supposed to be a journalist.
Goes in to fight Mosul. Now, with these 200 admirals and generals, they can't believe it. All I say is this. General George Patton, General Douglas MacArthur are spinning in their grave at the stupidity of what we're doing in the Middle East.
I'm going to go to Secretary Clinton. Secretary Clinton, you want Assad to go. You advocated arming rebels, but it looks like that may be too late for Aleppo. You talk about diplomatic efforts. Those have failed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, how would you start World
failed.
War, Hillary?
Would you introduce begun. The threat of U.S. military force beyond a no-fly zone against
war.
The Assad regime to back up
and that will create
diplomacy.
World War.
I would not use American ground forces in Syria. I think that would be a very serious mistake.
You don't need ground forces.
I don't think American troops should be holding territory, which is what they would have to do
well,
as
then why did you
an
vote
occupying
for it
force.
Over your
30
plus years in Iraq and Afghanistan.
I don't think that is a smart strategy. I do
That's
think
what
the use
so
of special forces,
smart.
Which we're using, the use of enablers and trainers in Iraq, which has had some positive effects, are
what?
Very much in our
what
interests. And
Mass
so I do
death?
Support what is happening. But let
so
me
what
just,
would you do differently than President Obama is
well,
doing?
Martha, I hope that by the time I, if I'm
everything.
I hope by the time I am president that we will have pushed ISIS out of Iraq. I do think that there is a good chance that we can take Mosul. And, you know, Donald says he knows more about ISIS than the generals. No, he doesn't. There are a lot of very important planning going on, and some of it is to signal to the Sunnis in the area, as well as Kurdish Peshmerga fighters, that we all need to be in this, and that takes a lot of planning and preparation. I would go after Baghdadi. I would specifically target Baghdadi, because I think our targeting of al-Qaeda leaders, and I was involved in a lot of those operations, highly classified
Boogie
ones,
man.
Made a difference. So I think that could help. I would also consider arming the Kurds. The Kurds have been our best partners in Syria as well as Iraq.
You created the
and
problem,
I know
Hillary,
there's
Hegelian
a lot of concern
reaction,
about
solution.
That
you
in some circles, but I think
Syria.
They should have the equipment they need
now
so the Kurdish
it.
And Arab fighters
convenient.
On the ground are the principal way
the
that we
crisis, by the way,
take Raqqa after pushing ISIS out of Iraq.
Thank you very much. We're going
to
move on.
She went over a minute over, and you don't stop her.
Yeah.
When I go 1 second over, it's like
you
a
had
big
many
deal.
Answers.
It's really very nope. interesting.
We've got a question over here from James
media.
Carter. Mr. Carter?
I love how he's beating them up. It's awesome.
My question is, do you believe you can be a devoted president to all the people in the United States?
That question begins for Mr. Trump. Hmm.
Absolutely.
Kind of a broad question.
I mean, she calls our people deplorable, a large group,
yeah,
and irredeemable. I will be a president for all of our people, and I'll be a president that will turn our inner
now,
cities
I'm sure they're
going to
ask about the whole
and we'll give
Black Lives Matter racist
to
card
people.
Is coming
and we'll
next,
give
obviously.
Economics to people, and we'll bring jobs back, because NAFTA, signed by her husband, is perhaps the greatest disaster trade deal in the history of the world.
Hillary's
not in this
on.
Country.
Donald Trump
it stripped
is
us of manufacturing jobs. We lost our jobs. We lost our money. We lost our plants. It is a disaster. And now she wants to sign TPP, even though she says now she's for it. She called it the gold standard. And by the way, at the last debate, she lied, because it turned out that she did say the gold standard, and she said she didn't say it. They actually said
liar.
That she lied.
Yeah,
okay?
Her mouth
and
is moving.
She lied,
she's
but
lying.
She's lied about a lot of things. I would be a president for all of the people, African Americans, the inner cities. Devastating what's happening to our inner cities. She's been talking about it for years. As usual, she talks about it, nothing happens. She doesn't get it done.
Yeah.
Same with the Latino Americans, the Hispanic Americans, the same exact thing. They talk, they don't get it done. You go into the inner cities and you see it's 45% poverty.
She's
African Americans have 45% poverty in the inner city.
She wants him to look domineering, so she
can play that vagina
card.
The education is a disaster.
Seriously,
jobs are essentially non-existent.
She might have another seizure.
I mean, it's, you know, I've been saying at big speeches where I have 20 and 30,000 people. What do you have to lose?
20 plus thousand
people
here in Arizona.
And she's been talking about the inner cities for 25 years. Nothing's going to ever happen. Let me tell you, if she's president of the United States, nothing's going to happen. It's just going to be talk. And all her friends, the taxes we were talking about, and I would just get it by osmosis. She's not doing me favors. But by doing all the others favors, she's doing me favors.
Mr. Trump, thank you.
But I will tell you, she's all talk. It doesn't get done. All you have to do is take a look at her Senate run. Take a look at upstate New York.
Your 2 minutes is up. Secretary Clinton, 2 minutes.
It turned out to
minutes.
Be a disaster.
You have 2 minutes, Secretary.
I like how it keeps inching closer and closer.
67% of the people voted to reelect me when I ran for my second term.
Yeah,
and I was very proud and very humbled by that. Mm-hmm. Mr.
Very
Carter.
Proud of your storied criminal career.
I have tried my entire life to do what I can to support children
to
and families. You know, right out of law school,
this.
I went to work for the Children's
hilarious.
Defense Fund. And Donald talks a lot about, you know, the 30 years I've been in public service. I'm proud of that. You know, I started off as a young lawyer working against discrimination against African-American children in schools and in the criminal justice
system. We're
done
with you.
I worked to make sure that kids with disabilities could get a public education, something that I care very much about. I have worked with Latinos. One of my first jobs in politics was down in South Texas registering Latino citizens to
and
be able to vote. So I have a deep devotion
like
to use your absolutely
partner,
correct word
Huma Abedin.
To making sure that every American feels like he or she has a place in our country. And I think when you look at the letters that I get, a lot of people are worried that maybe they wouldn't have a place in Donald Trump's America. They write me, and one woman wrote me about her son, Felix. She adopted him from Ethiopia when he was a toddler. He's 10 years old now.
She's going to come after the internet, by the way. She wants to shut this whole thing down. They did hand it off
to
October 1st,
and he said to his mother one day, will he send me back to Ethiopia if he gets elected?
North Korea.
You know, children listen to what is being said, to go back to the very, very first question. And there's a lot of fear that, in fact, teachers and parents are calling it the Trump effect. Bullying is up. A lot of people are feeling, you know, uneasy. A lot of kids are expressing their concerns. So first and foremost, I will do everything I can to reach out to everybody, Democrats, Republicans, independents, people across our country. If you don't vote for me, I still want to be your president.
Your
I want to be the best president I can be for every American.
Secretary Clinton, your 2 minutes is up. I want to follow up on something that Donald Trump actually said to you, a comment you made last month. You said that half of Donald Trump's supporters are, quote, deplorables, racist, sexist, homophobic, xenophobic, Islamophobic.
Wow. Talk about
later
hateful.
Said you regretted saying half. You didn't express regret for using the term deplorables. To Mr. Carter's question, how can you unite a country if you've written off tens of millions of Americans?
Well, within hours, I said that I was sorry about the way I talked about that, because my argument is not with his supporters. It's with him and with the hateful and divisive campaign that he has run and the inciting of violence at his rallies and the very brutal kinds of comments about not just
Black
women,
Lives Matter,
but all Americans,
is violent.
All kinds of Americans.
In a terrorist organization
and
funded by Soros,
what he has said
friend.
About African-Americans and Latinos, about Muslims, about POWs, about immigrants, about people with disabilities, he's never apologized for. And so I do think that a lot of the tone and tenor that he has said, I'm proud of the campaign that Bernie Sanders and I ran. We ran a campaign based on issues, not insults, and he is supporting me 100% because we talked about what we wanted to do. We might have had some differences. And we had a lot of debates,
thank you, Secretary.
But we believe
thank you,
that
Secretary.
We could make the
We're
country
finished.
Better. And I was proud
Shut
of
up.
I'm give you a minute, 20
We have a divided nation.
Listen to Anderson Pooper.
We have
Shut
a
up.
Very divided nation. You look at Charlotte. You look at Baltimore. You look at the violence that's taking place in the inner cities, Chicago.
You
take
Chicago.
A look at Washington, D.C. We have
so
an
dangerous.
Increase in murder within our cities, the biggest in 45 years. We have a divided nation because people like her, and believe me,
I said that today.
She has tremendous hate in her heart. And when she said deplorables, she meant it. And when she said irredeemable, they're irredeemable. You didn't mention that. But when she said they're irredeemable, to me, that might have been even worse.
She said some of them are irredeemable.
She's got tremendous hatred. And this country cannot take another 4 years of Barack Obama. And that's what you're getting with her.
Mr. Trump, let me follow up with you. In 2008, you wrote in one of your books that the most important characteristic of a good leader is discipline. You said if a leader doesn't have it, quote, he or she won't be one for very long. In the days after the first debate, you sent out a series of tweets from 3 a.m. to 5 a.m., including one that told people to check out a sex tape. Is that the discipline of a good leader?
No, it wasn't check out a sex tape. It was just take a look at the person that she built up to be this wonderful Girl Scout who was no Girl Scout.
You mentioned
by the way, just
tape.
So you understand, when she said 3 o'clock in the morning, take a look at Benghazi. She said, who's going to answer the call at 3 o'clock in the morning? Guess what? She didn't answer because when Ambassador Stevens...
The question is that the discipline of a
good
leader?
Shut up, Hooper.
600 times. Well, she said she was awake at 3 o'clock in the morning. And she also sent a tweet out at 3 o'clock in the morning, but I won't even mention that. But she said she'll be awake. Who's going to... The famous thing, we're going to answer our call at 3 o'clock in the morning. Guess what happened? Ambassador Stevens sent 600 requests for help. And the only one she talked to was Sidney Blumenthal, who's her friend. And not a good guy, by the way. So, you know, she shouldn't be talking about
that. I love when he takes that stab, too. It's awesome.
Tweeting happens to be a modern-day form of communication. I mean, you can like it or not like it. I have, between Facebook and Twitter, I have almost 25 million people. It's a very effective way of communication. So you can put it down.
Yeah, which is why the government owns it.
But it is a very effective form of communication. I'm not unproud of it, to be honest with you.
Why CNN is losing its ratings.
Clinton, does Mr. Trump have the discipline to be a good leader?
No.
I'm shocked to hear that.
Yeah, we're very shocked,
well,
Hillary.
It's not only my opinion. It's the opinion of many others.
Like your husband,
National
maybe?
Security experts, really. Republicans, former Republican members of Congress. But it's in part because those of us who have had the great privilege of seeing this job up close and know how difficult it is, and it's not just because
we need you out of there.
I watched my husband take a $300 billion deficit and turn it into a $200 billion surplus, and 23 million new jobs were created, and incomes went up for everybody, everybody. African-American incomes went up 33%. And it's not just because I worked with George W. Bush after 9/11, and I was very proud that when I told him what the city needed, what we needed to recover, he said, you've got it, and he never wavered. He stuck with me. And I have worked, and I admire President Obama. He inherited the worst financial crisis since the Great Depression. That was a terrible time for our country.
Your husband caused it, by the way, Hillary.
9 million
Yeah, and you worked with the same Wall Street banks that helped engineer it.
Secretary Clinton, we're moving on. $13
trillion in family wealth.
Thank you for the trillion-dollar bailout plan.
We
appreciate it.
He would send us back into
innocent
recession
Americans
with his tax plans.
Of their hard-earned money.
We are moving to an audience question.
For your Wall Street friends.
We have another. Mr. Trump, we're moving to an audience question.
Still 0% interest rates. Still.
Mr. Trump, Secretary
going to raise
rates. Clinton, we want to get to the audience.
Yeah.
Thank you
there
very
is no
much,
growth
both of
in this
you.
Country. It's a fraud.
We have another audience question. Beth Miller has a question for both candidates.
I wonder where this one. Racism?
Perhaps the most important aspect of this election is the Supreme Court justice. What would you prioritize as the most important aspect of selecting a Supreme Court justice?
We begin with your 2 minutes, Secretary Clinton.
Thank you. Well, you're right. This is one of the most important issues in this election. I want to appoint Supreme Court justices who understand the way the world really works.
To go after guns and freedom of speech.
Who have real life experience. Who have not just been in a big law firm and maybe clerk for a judge and then gotten on the bench, but you know maybe they tried some more cases.
And work
they
against
actually
America as much
understand
as possible.
What people are up against, because I think the current court has gone in the wrong direction, and so I would want to see the Supreme Court reverse Citizens United and get dark, unaccountable money out of our politics. Donald doesn't agree with that.
No, he does.
I would like
he wants
the
dark money of George
understand
Soros
that
out of your
voting
pocket.
Rights are still
super,
a big problem in many parts of our country, that we don't always do everything we can to make it possible for people of color and older people and young people to be able to exercise their franchise. I want a Supreme Court that will stick with Roe v. Wade and a woman's right to choose, and I want a Supreme Court that will stick with marriage equality. Now, Donald has put forth the names of some people that he would consider, and among the ones that he has suggested are people who would reverse Roe v. Wade and reverse marriage equality. I think that would be a terrible mistake.
So he doesn't want to kill and murder innocent babies.
I want a Supreme Court that doesn't always side with corporate interests. I want a Supreme Court that understands
but you're
because
in bed
you're
with
wealthy,
corporate interests
you can give
and
more
Wall
money
Street.
To something doesn't mean you have any more rights or should have any more rights than anybody else.
But you do.
So
you're totally
I have
detached.
Very clear views
you
about what
yourself
I want
to see email
to kind of change the balance on the Supreme Court. And I regret deeply that the Senate has not done its job.
Can't wait to watch this handshake
they
if they even give one. They might not even give one after this.
On the person that President Obama, a highly qualified person, they've not given him a vote to be able to have the full complement of 9 Supreme Court justices. I think that was a dereliction of duty. I hope that they will see their way to doing it. But if I am so fortunate enough as to be president, I will immediately move to make sure that we fill that. We have 9
thank
justices
you, Secretary
and they
Clinton.
Get to work on behalf
thank
of
you.
Our people.
Thank
Shut
you.
Up. You're out of time, Mr. Trump.
We're over it.
Justice Scalia, great.
Can I mention that too?
Judge.
Conspiracy.
Died recently. And
line in the sand
we have a vacancy. I am looking to appoint judges very much in the mold of Justice Scalia.
Thank God.
I'm looking for judges, and I've actually picked 20 of them so that people would see. Highly respected, highly thought of, and actually very beautifully reviewed by just about everybody, but people that will respect the Constitution of the United States. And I think that this is so important. Also, the Second Amendment, which is totally under siege by people like Hillary Clinton. They'll respect the Second Amendment and what it stands for, what it represents.
She's looking at
so important to me. Now, Hillary mentioned something about contributions, just so you understand. So I will have, in my race, more than $100 million put in of my money, meaning I'm not taking all of this big money from all of these different corporations like she's doing. What I ask is this. So I'm putting in more than, by the time it's finished, I'll have more than $100 million invested. Pretty much self-funding mine. We're raising money for the Republican Party, and we're doing tremendously on the small donation, $61 average or so. I ask Hillary, why doesn't she make $250 million by being in office? She used the power of her office to make a lot of money.
Yep.
Why isn't she funding, not for $100 million, but why don't you put $10 or $20 or $25 or $30 million into your own campaign? It's $30 million less for special interests that will tell you exactly what to do. And it would really, I think, be a nice sign to the American public. Why aren't you putting some money in? You have a lot of it. You've made a lot of it because of the fact that you've been in office. You made a lot of it while you were Secretary of State, actually. So why aren't you putting money into your own campaign? Just curious.
Well, thank you very much. Thank you. We're going to get on to one more question.
Yep. Shut up,
the Supreme Court, and I just want
shut
to quickly
up.
Say,
very quickly,
I respect the Second Amendment, but I believe there should be comprehensive
Did
background
you see that?
Checks.
That was
and we
a
should
freeze.
Close the gun show loophole.
I think almost
the
seizure's coming on.
We have
that's
one
crazy,
more question.
Dude.
As we
that's crazy. She
can.
Almost had a seizure there.
One more question from Ken Bone about energy policy. Ken?
What steps will your energy policy take to meet our energy needs while at the same time remaining environmentally friendly and minimizing job loss for fossil power plant workers?
Mr. Trump, 2 minutes.
Absolutely. I think it's such a great question because energy is under siege by the Obama administration, under absolute siege. The EPA, Environmental Protection Agency, is killing these energy companies. And foreign companies are now coming in buying so many of our different plants, and then rejiggering the plant so that they can take care of their oil. We are killing, absolutely killing, our energy business in this country. Now, I'm all for alternative forms of energy, including wind, including solar, et cetera. But we need much more than wind and solar. And you look at our miners. Hillary Clinton wants to put all the miners out of business.
Yeah.
There is a thing called clean coal. Coal will last for 1,000 years in this country. Now we have natural gas and so many other things because of technology.
Yeah, Hillary's
we have
capsizing.
Unbelievable. We have found like over the last 7 years, we have found tremendous wealth right under our feet. So good, especially when you have $20 trillion in debt. I will bring our energy companies back. They'll be able to compete. They'll make money. They'll pay off our national debt. They'll pay off our tremendous budget deficits, which are tremendous. But we are putting our energy companies out of business. We have to bring back our workers. You take a look at what's happening to steel and the cost of steel and China dumping vast amounts of steel all over the United States, which essentially is killing our steel workers and our steel companies. We have to guard our energy companies. We have to make it possible. The EPA is so restrictive that they are putting our energy companies out of business. And all you have to do is go to a great place like West Virginia or places like Ohio, which is phenomenal, or places like Pennsylvania, and you see what they're doing to the people, miners and others in the energy business. It's a disgrace.
Your time is up. Thank you,
sir. It's an absolute disgrace.
And actually, Secretary Clinton, 2 minutes.
Yeah, 2 minutes
well,
and then shut up.
Well, that was very interesting. First of all, China is illegally dumping steel in the United States, and Donald Trump is buying it to build his buildings, putting steel workers and American steel plants out of business. That's something that I fought against as a senator, and that I would have a trade prosecutor to make sure that we don't get taken advantage of by China on steel or anything else. You know, because it sounds like you're in the business or you're aware of people in the business. You know,
you notice how
that we are now for the first time ever energy independent.
Kinda,
we are not dependent
thing,
upon the Middle East.
Like,
but the Middle East still controls a lot of the prices. So the price of oil has been way down. And that has had a damaging effect on a lot
almost
of the oil
like she's
companies,
a nun,
right?
Or something like that.
We are, however,
that's
producing a lot of natural gas, which serves as a bridge to more renewable fuels, and I think
Mother
that's
Teresa
an important
we're looking at right now.
Transition. We've got to remain energy independent. It gives us much more power and freedom than to be worried about what goes on in the Middle East. We have enough worries over there without having to worry about that. So I have a comprehensive energy policy, but it really does include fighting climate change because I think that is a serious problem. And I support moving toward more clean, renewable energy as quickly as we can, because I think we can be the 21st century clean energy superpower and create millions of new jobs and businesses. But I also want to be sure that we don't leave people behind. That's why I'm the only candidate from the very beginning of this campaign who had a plan to help us revitalize coal country, because those coal miners and their fathers and their grandfathers, they dug that coal out. A lot of them lost their lives. They were injured. But they turned the lights on, and they powered our factories. I don't want to walk away from them. So we've got to do something for them. But the price of coal is down worldwide. So we have to look at this comprehensively, and that's exactly what I have proposed. I hope you will go to HillaryClinton.com and look at my entire policy.
One more audience question.
We've sneaked in one more question, and it comes from Carl Becker.
This will be interesting. They're actually going over
my
to ask the specific
both
question
of you
here.
Is, regardless of the current rhetoric, would either of you name one positive thing that you respect in one another?
That's interesting.
Mr. Trump, would you like to go first?
I had to slip that one in.
Well, I certainly will, because I think that's a very fair and important question.
No, it's not. They
I respect
inserted that because
Hillary's
children. Failing.
His children are incredibly able
and they don't
and
like you,
devoted,
so.
And I think that says a lot about Donald. I don't agree with
look at his children.
Nearly
like,
anything
we hate
else
you.
He says or does, but I do respect that. And I think that is something that as a mother and a grandmother
says.
Is very important to me.
They're trying to corner him right
so
now, by the way. That's why they inserted this
I
question as they're going over time.
This
debate should have ended already.
Has become, in part,
but they know
so,
Hillary's failing. She needs more airtime. Should be
so
ended.
Conflict-oriented, so intense, because there's a lot at stake. This is not an ordinary time, and this is not an ordinary election.
No, the country's divided.
We are going to be choosing a president who will set policy
the deplorables don't like you.
Not just 4 or 8 years, but because of some of the important decisions we have to make here at home and around the world, from the Supreme Court to energy and so much else. And so there is a lot at stake. It's one of the most consequential elections that we've had. And that's why I've tried to put forth specific policies and plans, trying to get it off of the personal and put it on to what it is I want to do as president.
She just changed the
and
whole conversation.
And that's why I hope
again.
People
you're
will
just supposed to say what you
check
like
on
about
that
Trump.
For themselves so that they can see that, yes, I spent 30
about?
Years.
Shut up.
Actually, maybe a little more, working to help kids and families. And I want
to
take all that experience to the White House and do that every single day.
Mr. Trump.
Well, I consider her statement about my children to be a very nice compliment. I don't know if it was meant to be a compliment, but it is a great. I'm very proud of my children. And they've done a wonderful job, and they've been wonderful, wonderful kids. So I consider that a compliment. I will say this about Hillary. She doesn't quit. She doesn't give up. I respect that. I tell it like it is. She's a fighter. I disagree with much of what she's fighting for. I do disagree with her judgment in many cases. But she does fight hard, and she doesn't quit, and she doesn't give up. And I consider that to be a very good trait.
Good
Thanks
answer.
To both of you.
Good answer.
I want to thank both the candidates. I want to thank the university here. This concludes the town hall meeting. Our thanks to the candidates,
I'm
the
Anderson
commission,
Pilper.
Washington
thanks
University,
for tuning
and
in.
To everybody who watched.
Please tune in on October 19th for the final presidential debate that will take place at the University of Nevada, Las Vegas. Good night, everyone.
Oh, we will. And thank you for your shitty, shitty performance. We really, really appreciate it. So, folks, that concludes our live presidential debate coverage. Let me turn the volume down on that if you can. I'll have some commentary here to close in just a minute. Yeah, it's okay. Looks like we've got no. Okay. So I think we just have to let Trump speak for himself. He just spoke for himself. And in my humble opinion, he dominated. He absolutely crushed the witch that is Hillary Rodham Clinton. Just crushed her. I think on every level. They did just what we suspected, what the controlled media would do. And they went straight for the vagina card, question number one. They went straight to the low brow, gutter trash commentary that made up the scandal that Hillary Clinton dug up on a hot mic, something Donald Trump said 10 freaking years ago when he didn't think he was being recorded in privacy. They did exactly what we said. I thought Trump handled himself brilliantly. He was very charismatic. And I think he won overall. I think he, bravo, did an absolutely fantastic job. He was strong. He was decisive. He went after Hillary on the Clinton Foundation, on her emails. He mentioned WikiLeaks. He emphasized again and again her bad judgment. And notably, I think he answered the last question here, which was conveniently inserted at the very, very end, even though they've gone overtime, because the media is trying to defend Hillary Clinton and trying to trap Donald Trump. I thought he answered that perfectly, to be frank with you. This was a Donald Trump win. We spoke about this earlier in our previous videos, that this was a make or break moment. This is a historic day in a make or break debate. I think Donald Trump did everything that he needed to do tonight. And this was his Ronald Reagan moment. He was poised. He was presidential. He was strong. He threw Hillary Clinton off guard. Hillary made one comment about fact-checking him. I mean, she can't even pronounce her words correctly. She had a pause for a moment, too. Almost looked like she was going to have a seizure at one point. She looked like she was taken off guard. I perceived her as weak. I think it was a success, largely. I think Trump and his campaign actually effectively played the wild card prior to this debate with the conference with Kathleen Willey and Juanita Broderick, who's accused Bill Clinton of rape. If you didn't already know, maybe you're just tuning in. That was a very, very good chess move. I think it rattled her to the core. I think it rattled her entire campaign. The image, you know, showing Bill as we're talking about this. I mean, it was incredible. It was tense. Now, I'll be curious to see the polling from Drudge and others, and I'm sure it's an overwhelming Trump domination. CNN's going to ridicule. They're going to try to destroy Donald Trump. They're going to say he lost and that he was divisive and all these things. It's total bullshit. It's a total lie. I mean, you could see from the questions, from question number one, who they're in favor of. And it's Hillary Rodham Clinton. It was all about what Donald Trump had said, some locker room talk, again, when he was speaking in private and didn't know he was being recorded. Well played, sir. Well played. I'll let Trump speak for himself. He won the night. It was an overwhelming victory. Stay tuned. We'll be broadcasting tomorrow. I'm Christopher Green. Thank you for tuning in. As always, you're watching AMTV, Alternative Media Television. Hard hitting it in your face. Click the link below if you haven't already. Start your free 14-day trial. Support us alternatively. Peace.